Hello, everybody, and welcome. Welcome to another episode of Blood Curdling Tales from the Loop. We are coming to you. This is episode 4.
Welcome to you, Cameron. How are you today?
Man,
does anyone ever welcome you to Tales from the Loop?
Welcome, Cameron.
Probably. I mean, Cameron. some of the chat does.
But some people say hi, Cameron.
Some people are already upset that I've shaved my beard.
It's just a jarring
shave. It'll never grow back.
It comes back.
Yeah. It comes back real quick. This is only one day.
It's like the Santa Claus.
Yeah, it really is. I'm a real Tim Allen.
Yes.
I'm a real Tim Allen.
You're the only one that has a
Y'all, thank you so much for watching. And obviously, as you can see, we're celebrating Halloween. We're going to be doing that this weekend next week. So that's going to be a fun one. You guys obviously can dress up as different things next week. Because chances are, although not guaranteed, we'll be out of Monster World.
Whoa.
This is improv, so we can't know what's going to happen.
We can't know.
Like, Ellie moves permanently to Monster
World. Wait, there's no script?
Bye.
Oh,
there is.
Bye.
There is no script. So, y'all, thank you so much for tuning in. This is episode 4, I believe, of Volume 3 of Blood Curdling Tales from the Loop, our fascinating, crazy little story using the Tales from the Loop system.
Yeah.
And, y'all, you're watching this on HyperRPG. It's our crazy little corner of the internet where we create some great content and where anything is possible. But with your participation, y'all, let's talk about this. Tomorrow.
You're throwing it weird.
Tomorrow. Is this true that this is happening tomorrow?
Yes.
Yes.
I was like, is this from last week?
Nope.
That's a really good question.
That's a valid question.
Tomorrow is the finale of Emily's The Fetch Quest.
Yes.
Part deux. And then, Emily's The Fetch Quest.
Part croissant.
Comma. And also part two of He Left It Dead.
Joe Star.
Some of the P&P crew.
Joe Dirt.
Zach and Maddie. And also then we got Magic the Gathering win condition. Yeah?
Yes.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yes.
It's so good.
Is it working?
It's working. Looks great.
Effect achieved.
Yes.
Yes, great.
And already we have a $5 donation towards Ricky.
Oh, nice.
Why Ricky?
He's not in costume.
did I get the memo on this? What?
The shirt works. We're going to figure out. We're going to Day of the Dead.
Maybe you'll become a lich.
Yeah, let's blame it on Cameron.
or a zombie.
Like I said, this weekend, Zach and Malika will be at TwitchCon. So check out Hyper's Twitter and their Twitters to see the schedule. Because if you're going to be at TwitchCon, go say hello. Go give the greetings.
Here, 10 candles will be happening on the floor.
Panic at the
This wasn't on the screen.
Well, I'm adding to the. I follow what my CEO does, and I'm sharing.
It might be
as someone who is up with the up here at HyperRPG.
Unfamiliar.
I'm not judging you for your lack of knowledge. I'm just merely here to encourage you to pay more attention.
Y'all, let's talk about the way you can participate in this show. And if you want to go and you want to affect the show, y'all are going to go to oneshot.straylogic.com so you can interact. So let's talk about this. First of all, you're going to tip $25 to give a player luck. And as stated, we're already $5 to a Ricky luck.
Woo!
Now, again, if you don't have $25, that's okay. Give what you can. And usually the rest of the chat room will help you.
They'll bump it all up.
So we're on our way to a Ricky luck. And what the luck is, if you don't know, it's a re-roll. I'm sure some people, I've seen the show's been going up, thankfully, on YouTube, and we've seen some people on Twitter talking about that they're catching up with the show.
And there's a podcast now.
Demoon Rules.
Yeah.
Thank you, Demoon Rules.
Demoon Rules, that was so nice.
Also, really quick, Naeem, can you turn down the music in our headphones just a little bit? Am I the only one?
It's real loud.
Yeah. The music in our headphones is put down a little bit. Sorry about that.
It's a real energy booster.
It's real good, though, but I want to be able to hear you.
Energy booster.
Thank you, Naeem.
So that's $25 for a luck, and that can be our four characters' names, or for today, our five characters.
What?
Oops.
What? That guy. Who's this?
So I feel threatened and underappreciated.
Which is weird, because you've never met this individual.
No, I'm just saying in this moment right now.
You should.
That's why I'm going 100 degrees right now.
Listen, you picked the right thing, though, because if you start sweating, it's just going to
soak
it all up.
What is it? It's from like basketball, where he's dripping all the water down his face.
So it's going to be hashtag Ethan, if you want to give Ethan some lucky lose. Yeah. Now this is where it gets fun. And also, actually, I probably haven't said this for a couple weeks, so I'll say this again. After four lucks, a character gets a broken which means it's an automatic success roll, but they're going to suffer a condition. Or you can just straight out do that with $100 if you put our character's name down. Yeah.
I used my pride last week, and
sure
I
did.
Don't remember what the repercussion was because we didn't deal with it in the moment.
You're right. We did not. You know what? We'll figure it out.
I just wanted to remind,
no, but thank you very much. Thank you very much. And we'll figure that out at the start of the show. $50 is where it's going to get fun because, as we said last week, we left our characters in Monster World.
Condition.
And some of them are monsters.
Monsters.
And so at $50, hashtag summon a monster.
Oh, God.
You can bring a monster into the game as an NPC that I have to portray. Now, it could be a classic monster. It could be your Freddy Krueger's. Or it can be a silent monster, and I have to describe everything we're doing. Or if you want to get creative and get crazy and just create your own monster, go for it. That's hashtag monster. That's 50.
It sounds like...
Oop, one moment.
Is that a headroom hashtag, Chrissy? Looks like you need some luck.
Chrissy has a luck.
Great.
Luck.
I can't hear that, and I can still hear this.
No. It said, is that a head wound? Hashtag Chrissy. Looks like you could use some luck.
Thanks, guys.
That
sounds like with the monster thing, like, Giant Replacement Baby could come back.
Giant Replacement Baby, Toblerone.
I don't know.
What is that?
Toblerone, too innocent for this world. As we have learned multiple times. At $75, you get by Trouble. That's hashtag Trouble, which has been a lot of fun the last couple weeks. Y'all have been coming up with some real good troubles. And man, the troubles we could probably get into in Monster World, where again, it's illegal to be a human.
Oh, I didn't remember that.
Thank God.
It's illegal
did we know
to
that?
Be a human.
Shit.
And at $100, you get to, and this is why it's important to remember, some of our characters are monsters. At $100, you get to unleash the player's instinct.
Whoa.
So we have our two vampires and our werewolf. And on this side of the table, two humans. For now.
Uh-oh. We'll see.
What happens when a vampire bites a vampire?
We're going to find out, brother.
Ooh, it is. It's like when the Na'vi put their braids together.
Cameron, why?
And Avatar.
Cameron!
James Cameron.
You mean with the
Avatar.
Horses?
And that's the
horse. when they rape the animals. I mean, come on. That's.
Yeah,
you all
right.
Saw the movie.
I mean.
I saw Fern Gully.
I want someone to clip that just so you can have that in your back pocket forever.
Oh my gosh.
So that's $100.
You're right, but whoa.
That's $100 for player's instincts. Or again, $100 to create a broken for a character. And again, at $250, we have an extended trouble. At $500, we have Echoplexes.
Ooh.
And Echoplexes is usually
you
where we can
Echoplexes.
Find some puzzle bookses, which I'm very excited
that's
about.
I'm straining too hard.
For today's show. And so, let's talk a little bit about where we left off last week. On last week's episode, our characters were dumped into Monster World after saving Chrissy. Oop, one moment.
As our favorite glove compartment gnome died last week, here's a giant replacement dingle for a hashtag monster.
Giant replacement dingle.
Thank you.
I got in trouble for that last week. Thanks, chat. Yeah.
Papa baby. I miss my boy.
But this is a giant replacement dingle. Good luck trying to carry him.
He's big. Big ass gnome.
Lap dog.
Yeah, exactly. Awesome. And apparently we are on our way to what is being called a Hyper Heroes Hydra as a monster.
Oh, my God.
So there you go. We can work our way there. I'm not sure what that will be, but we'll see when we get to it.
I can't wait to see how you're going to play it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Have you seen Iron Man? have I seen a very popular movie? Yes.
Hey, you know what? Hey, watch it.
6 months ago.
Be careful. One-third of those people I'm taking.
One-third.
If you donate enough, it'll be all three.
So, those are our incentives. And as we said, last week we left off, the characters were in Monster World, and our human beings were in a cell with another human being named Igor.
Yes.
That's why he was in the cell.
Human being. He's a slave.
Oh,
very
shit.
Sad.
We invited him to our world.
I mean,
we told him. We told him we were going
to
help him
I
get out.
I can't wait to hang out with Igor some more.
Oh, well, that's going to happen. As we begin this episode of Blood Curdling Tales
from the Loop!
Ooh, it's peaky.
A little hot.
Little hot.
Yeah, I am.
No problem.
As we open up on the cell, right where we left off last time. And again, it is evening. As the moon is full, should the lights hit you, the moonlight, that's when transformation
should appear.
Is it ever daytime in Monster World?
That's a good question. Or is it just like always overcast?
Perpetual night.
It's very brief. It's like the Vin Diesel movie Pitch Black.
I just want to.
It's like Norway, or it's like enough. Oz, Norway, in like the winter.
Yeah,
I just
want to
point
brief.
Out that it is a full moon out tonight.
It is.
It's
really?
A harvest moon.
Oh.
Oh,
woo, woo, woo.
Oh yeah, it actually
it's
is
quite beautiful.
I can't be a vampire and werewolf at the same time, or can I?
That's my OC.
Maybe
it's my Twilight OC.
Maybe if you get bit by a werewolf.
Uh-oh. Where could I find
it? Woo woo woo. I had two headbands on.
Oh. Technically a third.
A
with
third, yeah.
There's a lot going on.
Needs more headbands.
So what's your story? What's your world like? Eh? What do you tell me about your world?
I mean, it can't be much different than this world.
I don't know. I'm a slave. You got a werewolf over there and a vampire. You got those?
Not really.
We don't really got slaves in our world, which is why maybe you would like to come.
Are
to
you
our
sure?
World.
Yeah, the jury's still out of that, because even though it's not being reported on, there's a lot of awful trades going on with human lives.
Well,
sounds like you're informed. I bet you're the leader.
I don't know what just happened to me. Whoa! I went to a fugue state and come back. Hey, what the fuck's wrong with your hump?
Oh.
Rude.
Hashtag Chrissy make like a vampire and always count on chat to have your back.
Chrissy has another reroll.
Wow.
Hey.
I'm still having a hard time hearing
you. Anyway, you'll love our world. We should get there as soon as we can.
How's the coffee?
We're really young, so I don't know that we know coffee all that well.
I don't drink a lot of coffee, but... I hear good things.
Can we hear this conversation from far away?
Yeah,
you just hear Ellie go, yes!
What? What was that?
Coffee? Are you talking about coffee?
Yeah.
Speaking your normal accent, Ellie, it's weird.
Oh, that's weird, yeah. I'm sorry.
Coffee!
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm really bad at picking up other people's accents. Yeah.
It's all right. Not offended.
We have coffee. You just hear from like, coffee. From away.
We also have Coca-Cola.
Don't know what that is. Like coffee. Sounds good.
Coffee's
all right.
Cool.
And pizza. I don't know if you have pizza.
You got
here.
Pretzels.
All right. I'm hearing a lot.
A lot of food that can be made in a microwave.
What's a microwave?
It's a science. Oh. It's a science oven.
Science oven.
Didn't it's help break it down. Just added
it's,
two
it's,
words
it's
to
a,
one.
It's cool.
It's a little oven that uses nuclear power to instantly cook things.
Science oven. Yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
If only my master was working on that and not bringing back corpses.
Wait, so your master is
mean?
Frankenstein?
Yep.
Oh, snap, guys.
So that big guy that we saw out there, that was his monster?
That's Frankenstein's monster, not Frankenstein. It's okay. People get confused. It's all right. Understandable. It's like as if you were a famous person and then you had a baby who became more famous.
Okay, all right, so it's Frankenstein's monster.
Mm-hmm.
He said he was trying to smell, he smells some humans. Does he eat humans or what?
Does Frankenstein eat the monster?
Does the monster eat humans or what?
I don't know if he digests, he was dead.
Hmm.
Maybe he's got a busy mouth, you know.
Oh, okay, so like a baby.
So humans are illegal here.
Yeah.
So what was he trying to...
And they try. Do they try to eat humans, or they just don't like them?
It's a mix of things, right?
Oh, yikes!
They sometimes they'll eat them, right? Depending. Sometimes they'll try and lobotomize them, try and make them slaves, things of that nature.
We should get out of here.
Yeah, I have a question, Igor.
Shoot.
Like, because you're really smart, because you must have some sort of trait.
Oh my gosh! Yikes!
Really good at listening. I'm a friend in need.
I can tell. And as my new friend, I want to know if you are aware of any secret passages in this castle.
Yeah.
Great.
As he walks over and just grabs some hay and moves it to the side.
Three of us are good. There. Okay.
Don't know about you.
Wait.
Not our problem because they're monsters. They're going to be fine. We're not.
Can we just come out? Why are we
all got to get back together. What the heck are you talking about?
Why are we
is there a passage to the other cell also?
Not aware, but I'll tell you this. You might have strength to take off the door if you turn into a dog. That said, it'd be hard to control yourself. You might try and rip up your friend.
I mean, when have I not? No, that's a really, I'm sorry, that's a poor taste joke.
Yeah, it's
I
a
had
poor
a
taste.
Thing. I've already turned into a creature before. This is definitely not my first circus.
It was
ooh,
not
what,
a
what'd
good
you
town.
Turn into?
I don't know if you're familiar with a thing called the chaos.
Nope. Well, the concept.
The concept of chaos?
Yeah.
Interesting. Well, where we're from, there's some craziness going on. And basically, I got infected with this darkness, and I became a very powerful dark version of myself.
She became an asshole. If I
oh,
say,
my
I
goodness.
See, I'm like that when I don't have coffee.
That's fair.
No, I understand.
All right.
She's
all right.
She was kind of cooler, yeah. though.
I definitely felt more confident. Maybe I wasn't. I think I was an asshole. Yeah, probably. Yeah.
Teeny weeny.
Anyways, so... All right, Leanne, what are we going to do here?
What do you want, Igor? What can I offer you?
I mean, nothing. I won't get out of this world. You already offered me that. I'm not.
We got you.
I'm not,
we got you.
Yeah,
I'm not,
but why is it just a two for one deal?
We don't have the secret passage in
I
our cage.
I start walking down the hall, ignoring the conversation.
I hate you, Chrissy. You is why you get mad at me for being mean to you. But guess what? You're an asshole.
I can't
you
hear anything.
Powers.
You're an asshole.
You have powers.
Roll
just pull open
roll
the door.
Investigate if you can hear it.
Fine. And I want to roll to see if I can just like out of my I'm so pissed off at Chrissy. I want to see if my vampire powers, if I can just like with vampire strength no. tear okay. off the front of the door.
Well, I have two lucks. It's worth.
Oh,
wait.
I'm not challenging you. I'm pissed off at you.
It's fine. I'm not. And not worth it.
So you do hear her.
I
you
think
are
I hear
worth
her.
It, though.
I know I was going to piss her off.
What am I rolling off?
Come on, Leanne. I could turn into a really cute little dog.
So
this could be really fun.
Tell me again what you're trying to do.
I'm trying to tear off the front of the gate, the front
ooh,
of the cage.
That's gonna be. I think that's gonna be a tinker. You
okay.
gotta be able to find the
tinker,
right part. The
so
right
that's
part.
Mind, right? Or
so when we're and when we're monsters, it's kind of like the negative rolls. So we have
yeah.
to get no
is that
successes.
True?
All right,
okay.
Check.
That was true last week.
Check yes. is two. So then, you know what? Last week I realized that when we were broken, we should be actually be adding dice. As a broken hero, as a negative hero.
Ooh,
yeah.
I fucking like that.
Yeah, because like I
yeah,
was,
make it equally as hard.
I was
yeah.
deducting dice when I should have just been like
adding them
because
yeah, yeah, it's, mm-hmm. yeah, you don't want to get the sixes.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on, Leanne. I mean, it'd be really cool if I turned in. Oh. Maybe I'm a cute little doggy. Maybe
no,
I'm like a really
no, no,
cute
no.
little werewolf.
I'll handle
know.
It. I'm already. I don't want you getting turned into something else. All right, I got that's no successes. That is a success.
Yeah, and I just want to turn
so,
into
oh,
a
so
werewolf.
So you got no successes.
Let's,
yes.
let's
okay,
not
great.
Turn into things if we can help it.
Yeah, I didn't
yeah.
think
you
Chad
see Ellie
kind of
like kick like
part.
A kick a stone, and it's like Charlie Brown
like,
music.
I don't
she's
trust
like,
you.
Yeah. I just, well, I mean, I'm, if that, maybe I'm a
you're
cute
not,
little doggy.
You're not
you don't
great
have a good track
with power.
Are you
so
just,
you
are you still
over,
going
oh, yeah,
down
no,
the hallway
on,
and you're just?
So as you walk over and you pull this character right out, Igor's like, very impressive. Sad part is, if we fail, I gotta fix that.
You're not
we're not gonna
we're
fail.
We're not gonna
you're
fail. We're gonna get you out of here.
Hey, hey,
you know
Igor?
What? I'll fix it for if we fail.
Oh, you come back up the.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We might fail.
No, it's gonna be fine. All right, let's.
We'll
get
out. You probably won't. In reality.
Thank you,
don't
Big Cat.
That's not a very nice thing to say to
him. Don't tell him that.
It's likely.
We need his help.
I get drunk somewhere.
So you rip the cage door out.
But we gotta get to the other cell.
Yep, so you gotta rip out the other one.
Oh, sorry to that.
Come on,
cell?
I mean,
on.
Hey,
yeah.
hey, there's a little
yeah,
bit. There's a little bit.
You guys made a deal with Igor, right? You guys made a deal with Igor. But what about us? You didn't make a deal for us, right?
We're our boy in the same group.
He said that he would take you if you could get
yeah.
over here. He didn't know how to get to you otherwise.
Fine.
Yeah, I wasn't lying. I wasn't doing a bit.
Come on, there's a little bit.
Right, fine. And then I.
You see why we're so hard on them.
Three. What are you talking about?
Are they your ego?
No.
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 Question. I pause, and I go, no.
No successes. So therefore
come on, there's like a little bit of moonlight right there. It'll be really cool.
So you rip that so off. Cool.
Didn't
stop
the last
it,
time you got a little moonlight on you, like your limbs were breaking?
Yeah, it definitely, I mean, yes, it definitely was painful, okay. but I do want to see me, how cute I am as a dog.
No.
I don't want to see
he
that.
He said it was gonna be. He said last time he that you're gonna be painful. It was gonna be painful. Yeah. Your bones are gonna break.
What I did for love.
Oh, you're breaking into song over there. Let me hear it. No one sang to me since my mom died.
Oh God, that's a little bit too much pressure.
No, it's yeah. not.
Okay.
Roll charm.
Wow.
God, is this how I
Can
get
you
my
sing
broken?
Like this, Mama? Yes or no?
Is this a trouble?
Sounds like it. Charm 5, 6, 7. I mean, it's looking pretty good. I'm gonna use one of my lucks.
Oh my God.
It's looking pretty good.
Gonna use my last luck. I don't want to sing right now.
You asked for
it. I did. That is 2 successes. Thank you, chat.
So he's looking at you, waiting for you to sing.
Okay, let's go.
Do I sing? I have to sing. Is that what I rolled for? Is to sing?
No.
What I
this
did
long, awkward
for
pause.
Love.
She's singing for you still.
Never mind.
Jesus.
No. Ooh, yo, Eva, that's over. Nice, all right?
You were just yelling at her.
So what? She offered to sing for you. That's not very kind of you to like just like cut her off when she's trying to make you feel better.
Okay.
You're wrong. I guess she's trying to make me feel better.
Yeah, trying to make you feel better.
Right. We humans here, we should probably get going.
All right. You guys like make your way down this secret passageway. I should probably go first.
That tracks.
Lead on.
Can Ellie just like dip the back of her head in the moonlight she gets like little ears?
Yeah.
Okay. She just kind of gets like a little spritzel.
It
spritz
is.
Of, spritzel. A spritzel of
you
moonlight.
You feel the cartilage in your ear snapping.
Ow! Ellie! That was harder!
That hurt worse than I thought.
Stop!
Oh, look how cute I am!
Stop! Your ears look weird! It's not okay. I see you. I caught you. Stop.
Ooh.
Am I turning it up? Got it. Did it the wrong thing.
She's like making it louder.
As Igor is making his way down the steps, and you guys start to hear what sounds like a conversation between something that sounds quite large and someone that sounds fairly normal.
Bubba.
Hello?
Bubba.
Bubba, baby, Bubba.
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
Bubba, I wanna go play.
What is this?
What is that?
Ethan.
Bubba, you gonna play? We're gonna go play.
Who?
That.
The biggest monster of all time is already amongst you. Hashtag Ethan rules number one.
Oh.
Let's rev this double unicorn rainbow.
So Ethan has a reroll.
Yes.
So as you guys go turn the corner, you do see what looks like a giant dingle. And
oh my God.
Ethan.
Wait, what?
Ethan?
Is that you, Ethan?
Oh, hey. This is weird.
Hello? Hello?
What are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
I don't know. I've been here.
What the hell is that? Is that a dingle?
Yes, dingle. Yeah, yeah. Like, hey. You know, like, here, let me.
Hey, what's going on? What's up?
I am
Come
so.
Come to Papa, dingle.
What is sorry.
Oh, Papa baby.
That's a good
I am
dingle.
Beyond
and this dingle,
apologetic.
He's so sticky.
Dingle is very sticky, very sweaty.
Ew.
What?
Ew. Good,
who the fuck is this?
This is your replacement. This Papa is the Chrissy baby. In the other universe. The fact that he's here makes no sense.
Papa baby,
what
Papa.
What are you doing here? Baby, is this
Papa
you?
Baby.
Is this you? Hello? Baby,
Janelle.
What?
Nope. Oh, wait, who is that? Lee.
Oh, wait,
you like this guy?
Wait, it's you. You're the I saw the picture, the visions, and I'm like the better you. That's what everyone said. I don't know.
I'd like to punch him. Oh.
Okay. Roll moves.
Immediately off the bat.
Who, me? But my baby.
But my baby.
Your ugly child? Oh shit, I failed.
To clarify, he is not actually a child, like a child, he's a gnome.
He's a
large,
gnome.
Sticky, handsome gnome.
So as you go for this punch, Dingle stops you, grabbing your hand, and then brings you in for a big hug, and it's very warm.
Doesn't this feel good?
How does Dingle smell?
Oh man, he's a giant gnome. He probably smells like sugar cookies.
Okay.
Oh, no, I guess maybe that sounds
sticky,
more like
sweaty,
fungus
cold
or
sugar
something.
Cookies.
No,
but our gnomes can smell like sugar. It's fine.
Sure.
I start.
This is a big gnome. He's a we call them big gnomes.
You know big gnomes.
We know big gnomes.
So is he considered a monster?
Yeah.
What about that?
It's a vampire.
Who me?
That's a vampire.
Yeah, Ethan. What are you doing here?
Why did you become
here?
A vampire?
I don't know, dude. I woke up and I was already here. It's not like I've woke up naked. I've woken up like as a woman.
But
I've woken up.
But Echo took you.
Yeah, he did.
And did and he bring you here?
He left
what?
Me. He dropped me somewhere.
Do you have a teleport a teleported puppy? A telepuppy?
Those are a thing?
Yeah.
What? I have one of those, yeah.
Have you trained him?
No!
He probably dropped you off randomly.
Okay.
You gotta train your telepuppy.
Dude, I've been through so much fucking weird shit.
Oh
like,
God.
This is not. I'm not even freaking out right now.
I mean.
Oh, shit.
You have those too?
Oh.
They're weird, aren't they? So you're a vampire too. I wonder why you're a vampire too.
I'm thirsty.
You look. I'm hungry.
Well, does that mean? Does that mean Bobby's here?
Who?
Who?
No one.
You already have Brittany in the other world. I don't know.
I'm Brittany. I don't want to
we haven't this caught is, up. I haven't caught crazy. Up about where. What's going on with Brittany?
I don't know. She asked me on a date. I said yes because I feel like it is Bobby, but I don't know if it is Bobby. I'm trying to keep her at a distance because I don't know. I don't want everything what happened to happen again.
Smart. You don't want to get too close. Sometimes you know you get really close to someone they break your heart.
And listen, I got
you. Might learn. Yeah. Well, hold on. You might learn and grow throughout all that. But sometimes it still hurts. What were you saying?
I agree. But I got my heart kind of broken, and then I found love again, too.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yes.
It makes you think, like, hey, it was worth it at least to fall in love that one time, even if my heart's broken. And as he keeps talking, Dingle comes up and gives him a hug. He's like, that's nice.
I found out if you don't have a heart, it's all gravy, baby.
No, you have, you have a heart. You're a vampire. You have a heart. You're just not beating.
Oh, shit.
You have one, though.
Oh,
yeah, that's, it's not like taking out of your body.
Yeah, it's like a toenail. You don't really feel it till it hurts.
Jeez.
I okay. don't feel this like I have heart.
I gotta get used
I'm
to this.
Cold,
this is all great. We should get out of here.
Well, you were saying you was hungry. Hungry.
I'm thirsty.
You're thirsty?
Yeah.
All right. I think we gotta sneak into the kitchen because if we don't feed these two, they're gonna attack you two. Lickety quickity.
What?
Lickety quickity.
What's that?
Real quick.
Okay.
Real quick. All right.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's go.
It's like Dingle comes walking up behind you. What are we doing? What are we doing?
You're gonna get Papa some drink.
Okay.
Hey. I don't care where it comes from, dude. I don't. Oh my god, I need.
Ethan, apparently, Dingle can offer you some delicious rainbow blood.
Stop it! I didn't mean to do that. I didn't. Do not mean to do that. Why would you just tail on me like that?
It's not telling on you. I just feel like if you really like him, you would want to be honest.
What's she talking about?
That's true, Papa.
What's she talking about, Willis?
Papa, are you so thirsty? Dingle, what do you mean? Before.
Hey, Ricky, how are you doing?
What did you do to Dingle?
I just want to get out of here.
Before this, whatever, this giant Dingle.
Oh, here's the kitchen.
I ate Dingle before.
What the fuck?
I'm sorry.
You
Some told me to do it. It wasn't my fault.
I was going to eat Dingle. He looks delicious.
What do you mean?
Doesn't he look good? He's huge.
Papa want to eat Dingle?
He does look really good.
So sticky and cold.
Ew,
and
no. Does not look appetizing at all.
We rolled to eat Dingle.
He smells so sweet.
No. We rolled to jump on Dingle.
The kitchen's.
Both of you roll
Chrissy
first.
Was right. The kitchen's right here.
It's so close. It's so close.
We've got some body. Are we,
I don't want to watch this.
Negative rolls?
Negative rolls.
So no successes?
Roll. Yeah.
I can deal with that.
I don't like these notes.
What is it, just body or is it force?
It's going to be force.
Force? Okay.
No success.
No successes.
So Dingle, because he loves his papa mama so much, he opens up his
No, don't do that.
For the
Come
sacrifice.
On.
As Yikes. You both
Come
jump
on,
up.
Little Dingle,
and the three of you just see this
word.
Eruption of Papa's rainbow blood just on the ground.
I am just
this rainbow blood hitting the ceiling.
If I didn't have to see any more of that, it would be too soon.
What just
okay, so
tastes so
good. So we need to get out of here as soon as possible.
So Igor, while they're eating, is there any place where we can get some weapons?
This is normal to me.
Great. Not so much for us.
Sweet.
Hashtag monster Spock the Fishman. Think the shape of water.
Oh, hell
oh,
yeah!
No.
Hold on.
Someone's gonna fuck a fish.
Doomfish?
I just saw Leslie Jones's because I haven't seen the movie.
Oh, her Twitter reactions.
Yes, and I didn't know that he broke his finger like that, and then I didn't realize that sex happened, and that's a lot.
Oh my god, spoilers.
But
it's a real good movie.
It's a great movie. I love that movie.
That one.
It's a. Have you seen the movie?
No.
You got to see it.
I don't think you could pay me.
It's a good movie. So I'm sure. It's a very sweet, but now that I know fantastical breaks, movie. Yeah.
Now that I know he breaks his finger like that,
it's pretty gnarly. It's pretty gnarly.
Don't deal with
it's pretty grossy.
So you want to go get weapons?
Yeah.
We will get to Spock the Fish
Man.
Yeah, fish man thing.
So this guy's her blood's happening.
Yeah, and I don't need to watch that.
Yeah. And Igor's like, all right, come on, mate.
Okay. I tug on Ricky's jacket and like follow.
Yeah. Oh, you're okay. And then are you?
Yeah, I'm following them.
So as Igor leads you through, and you hear footsteps in the room, and Igor goes, "Get back!" He pushes you guys back, okay. And that's when you see the Frankenstein monster.
Oh no!
From last week that got you guys walking through the halls.
He's not in the kitchen though.
No.
But he's like walking past
he's
the door.
Just walking.
Yeah.
Which doesn't have a door. It's just open. If castles, if I understand castles like I do.
The Igor's like, listen, just don't move. He's stupid.
That's not very nice.
But it's true. Just listen, sometimes the truth ain't nice.
Listen, I don't like being told to be quiet by you, okay?
I'm not telling you to be
quiet. You're not in charge of me. You're not the boss of me.
As the monster goes walking by and opens up a window, causing moonlight to come peeping in.
Uh-ohs.
Oh, no!
You're going to roll, unless you want to get hit by the moonlight.
Oh, no.
She wants I mean, I'm feeling in this moment, she'll kind of like, she tries to scoot out of the way because she knows that this is a pretty, like, stealthy situation, and the last thing that this stealthy situation needs is a werewolf transformation.
Okay.
Sneak.
Okay.
Sneak.
Does she get truly sneak, or is that officially out of our...
In the alternate universes, they've kind of been thrown out.
Training is training.
It's fun rolling dice with these gloves.
You're right, though.
Uh-oh.
Now, keep in mind, you are a monster, even if you're not a werewolf right now.
Oh, I am? Okay, cool. Then that was a success.
Okay, great.
Nice.
So you are able to kind of, like, scooch right as, like, the moonlight hits right between you and Ricky as this moonlight just kind of peers down. Whoop, one moment.
A throwback hashtag monster. King of the vampires, Tiny Steven Dorff.
I was waiting for that last week.
So as
welcome back.
This moonlight comes down and right between the two of you.
As fun as it would be, I'm trying really hard. Oh, you don't want to be Dark Ellie again?
No, I want to be Dog Ellie.
Dog Ellie isn't werewolf Ellie. It's not the same.
You're walking up with like rainbow blood dripping from your chin.
I'm getting their attention.
Ellie, like, I would like, I don't want you to turn into anything else, because I don't know, it was real scary last time you turned into something else.
I kind of do.
Well, Ethan, you weren't even there, you don't even know what we're talking about.
I heard about it.
I know, but.
You eating a gnome isn't scary and uncomfortable?
Yeah, you attacking Carol.
It was so good.
I told you I was sorry about that.
I know, and I'm sorry for being a ding dong when I was Dark Ellie, but I mean.
But let's not.
Look,
yeah, let's not.
If worst, if it comes to, if it comes to like a fight, I'm gonna do it because I know I'll be able to take something down.
Did he walk away?
The monster?
Yeah.
Well, he opened up the curtain, and then you hear like, "What are you doing?"
Because I want to make sure with this conversation is not gonna be overheard.
They're pretty close to each other. I'd say this is more of like
us talking.
Yeah. And then you just hear, "What are you doing?" As you look, you see like about a 3-foot vampire comes along, scooching up
I
to the curtain.
Drooled.
Close that! I like it dark and mysterious. As he closes the curtain, Frankenstein's monster puts his head down in sadness. I'm gonna go to the kitchen and get a snack.
No.
Are there two entrances to this kitchen?
There's the way you guys came.
Okay.
And then there's forward where he's coming from.
I start scrambling everybody towards the way we came.
Yes.
Should we hide? But I mean, like, Frankenstein's monster is still in the hallway.
Well, if we go out as they're coming in.
I should.
We've done that before.
Yes.
The old switcheroo.
Whatever Cameron says.
Ooh, apparently, wait. So we have.
I'm going to eat all the chocolate. This is what's going to happen.
You can eat the Toblerone.
No. I want Snickers and Toblerone.
It's not enough.
Those are the good ones.
Can you pass me a little peppermint patty?
Girl.
Can you pass me a Snickers too?
Oh.
Do you have any blood flavor?
I'm hungry.
So
There's no blood flavors.
We have. I know we have. We have Spock
you're
the
one
fish.
Of those people?
We have Spock the Fishman. Do we have another?
So good.
We apparently have another monster up, and I'm not sure which one it is. So someone's gonna have to tell me that in the chat.
So
and also because we did hit 250, we have hit our first extended trouble.
Oh no!
Yeah.
So Tiny Steven Dorff, while you're trying to tell this grandma, and you're like, should we hide? Tiny Steven Dorff has already walked into the kitchen. He's like, what the fuck?
Vampires, do something!
And Igor's like, master.
No! He's not pretending to do that. No,
master.
Mike,
you don't have to pretend anymore.
Shut up, Lig Master. These are my people. Them all monsters.
We're your new slaves as well.
Yes.
Yes. <Great.
laughs> We'll cook you dinner.
We're
gonna be dinner.
I'm pretty hungry. To be honest,
you just ate.
You two. I don't know you. Who are you two?
I don't know you, little guy.
This is my castle. This is my castle. You're my castle.
Okay, but guess
this
what?
This is your castle. I thought it was the.
I'm bigger than you. It might be my castle.
Ethan! That's not nice to tell somebody.
Come here, little guy.
You like this guy?
I like the scene from Elf.
Roll move.
Holy shit. What is that?
You call know me, what, Chrissy? You
call
keep
me
talking trash
elf.
About him,
one
but you know
time.
What? Guess
I got
what?
Some move. I got
he's
some
the
move.
Other half. He's the other part of you. He's you. So everything you don't like about him, you must not like about
can
yourself.
Can we see some move?
Right?
Fuck. Two successes.
And
so two minuses, right? Come here, little guy. Come on.
So he jumps on top of you.
Oh, shit.
You have that's your trouble roll, which you have failed.
Oh, God.
He starts, like, choking you with his little hands. You are suffering.
Oh, God.
So you are suffering a condition that's going to be, let's say it's going to be an injury.
Oh.
So he's like,
he's so strong. Why is he so strong?
His little
I
hands
thought
are
you were
screaming.
For the
oh, no. Whose idea was this?
Yours.
I want to try. I want to try the Vulcan death grip on him.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Help!
Roll. I guess roll calculate.
Oh god.
Oh my gosh. If you get this, it's gonna. I'm gonna have a remark.
God. This is your trouble roll.
God.
Uh oh.
This is an extended trouble. You're all in trouble.
Yeah, we're all in trouble.
What happened to me? My pride, though. What happened?
What?
Did we figure out how the pride affected me?
Pride's usually a free. Pride's usually just a free auto success.
Yeah. You just don't. It doesn't get hurt.
No, you're good.
No, you just get an auto success.
What happened?
Fail.
Great. So as you squeeze, I'm trying to Vulcan neck pinch.
Yeah, get him.
Vampire. His head just like all the bones break as he bites down on your hand.
It's working.
Activate Ellie Wolf mode. Hashtag instinct.
Uh oh.
So
well,
while this is happening, boom, 100 dots. So yes, instinct hits,
dang,
and that's gonna
thank
go.
You.
Instinct is gonna go for about 2 to 5 minutes, depending.
Okay.
So.
Ruh-roh.
So do you walk into the sunlight, the moonlight?
I think Ellie's like backing up, and she accidentally backs up into like a little sliver windows.
Beautiful. So as his little head turns and he bites down on your hand, you kind of back up and you hit the moonlight, and suddenly it feels like. Your back breaks and extends. Your hands grow out American Werewolf style. And you get to say, oh, God, before your words transform. And it just turns into growling.
You look so cute.
And Igor looks over and goes, oh, shit. He grabs Ricky and goes running out of the room.
Ricky!
He's stronger than he looks.
I'm dating the wrong man.
So
Jesus, man.
You're a werewolf now. What do you want to do?
I'm going to attack this this vampire.
Okay. And here's the thing. Because of instinct, if you fail this roll, you attack one of your friends instead.
What?
Ellie, help.
Yikes.
So this is going to be... this is going to be... Comprehend. This is going to be comprehend.
If I fail, do I get a broken or something or condition? I don't remember.
You got conditions.
Okay. Shoot, and oh man, a reroll would be great right now. I can't get any successes. Uh oh, Ellie's too good at this.
Uh oh, that was one success.
Fantastic. So the only human in the room is crazy. So you start bounding, and it looks like you're gonna help. you might be helping Chrissy when Steven Dorf Vampire just leaps off and goes to the ceiling, and you don't so much stop to go after Steven Dorf Vampire as you keep just going forward to Chrissy.
Well,
Ellie,
what do you want to do?
I have my sunglasses, so I want to like.
I like your outfit.
Are you? Or her?
No, her.
She's naked. What are you talking about?
Well, I'm not naked. I've got like clothes.
Look at her ears.
Look
at her ears. They're so cute.
This is the guy you like.
She stinks.
I take my sunglasses and shove them down her throat.
Wow. Oh, say bye to your sunglasses. I'm going to eat them.
So do you want to try and do anything? What are you going
to
try and do?
Stop her from doing that to Ellie.
You're going
to
roll force. You're going to roll. You're going to roll move.
So I get to roll five.
So we have our, have our next monster.
But I lose a dice because I have a condition. But I get two because I'm using my sunglasses.
Do I get to roll off any? Do I get to try to get out of this?
We'll see how she does.
Shit!
Fuck! Ooh. I don't have any looks, and I rolled one positive.
So we both failed.
Great. Yeah. So as you try to swipe and she tries to stop you, you just leap onto Chrissy. We cut to Ricky and Igor.
I assume you're taking me to like where there's a trophy room of Monster Hunter equipment.
Nope. And he opens up a little passage and dumps you down this passage slide as he jumps down it too. And you guys go sliding around, landing in the moat outside the castle.
Well, what the hell did you do that for?
I saved your life. You're welcome.
But all my friends are in there.
Not anymore. I mean, they're probably dead. I mean, that's why. I don't mean they're not in the room. I mean, they might be dead.
No, that's not acceptable. I'm going back for them.
Okay, good luck. It's a slide. You climb up there.
Wow, Ricky. Wow.
If you don't, so you're not going to help me? Well, then you're not going to come with us.
Oh.
And then Ryzy says that you hear bubbling sounds coming from the water.
Oh, shit.
Oh, here he is.
Is this trash compactor?
No.
No, it's something way more sexier. It's Doug Jones in a latex fish man suit.
So as we come back, you're now
I'm into it.
You're on top of Chrissy, full world style. Ricky, if you want to try and do anything.
I'm free, and Chrissy
free.
Is basically me. And
so I leave.
I love myself. So I'm going to do something. I want to try to snap Ellie out of it and save the fleshy, soft Chrissy.
Okay, that's going to be empathize.
I have a lot of muscle tone.
Empathize.
Yeah, you're right. Empathize.
You might recognize that her.
Mine. Yeah, that's on her too.
For the record.
Easy fail, boys. Easy fail. Big fail. Some success.
So how do you, what do you do?
I see a vision of Chrissy, and I see myself in her, and I see how crazy Ellie is. And I want her, so I jump on her back and go,
You bite her?
Yeah. not to drink blood, just to do some damage. I'm just doing
what
some surface
happened?
Damage to try
this
to.
What happened because you left?
Apparently.
Great.
Ellie, take it easy.
So do you want to try, what are you going to try to do?
Don't want to get bit. So throw this dude off my back.
Well, he already bit you.
Well, now it's like, yeah, now I'm no longer, I feel like I'm no
He's
longer really
you.
Focused.
I spit at you. I poke.
Yeah. So he bites you. Blood goes onto Chrissy's face.
Oh, my God.
This werewolf.
Oh,
blood.
My God.
It's working. I'm saving you.
Stop saving me.
As Steven Dorf is on the ceiling going, get out of my house!
I thought this isn't your house, asshole. I thought it was Frankenstein's house.
We live together.
Are you in a relationship?
Yes.
Okay.
That's fine. As long as you tell us what's going
just
on.
Just wanted to be clear.
Why? Why do I owe you an explanation about my marital status? Deal with it! Deal with the confusion of my sexuality. It's not your business.
I want to throw Ethan off my back. I want to like kind of slam Ethan into like a thing of glassware.
Right. Roll force.
Ethers.
This is like the Skrillex 80s mix.
Oh, that is no successes, so I'm successful.
So you throw him
oh,
off.
Oh, shit! You're so strong!
And it's such a force, you throw Ethan out the window.
Ethan! Ellie, stop!
I'll be back! Oh!
Can you fly, though? You're a vampire.
Can I?
Roll comprehend. Yeah, roll comprehend.
Can you what?
Can you fly? He's a vampire.
Zero mind. Looking good.
Because of you.
I don't have mind. Here we go.
Oh, I know. Zero. I mean, we know he likes to count beans.
I'm an awesome monster.
Do you have my page?
Ah, fuck. I have a...
Yeah.
He does, right?
I got one success.
You got one success?
Yeah.
So, as you're about to turn into a vamp, as you're about to turn into a bat,
bat time.
You land in the moat.
Fuck!
Next to Ricky and Igor.
Oh, hey. I'm not used to this thing yet. How you guys doing?
There's something in the water.
Huh?
And then right then, this hand comes up and just wraps its around your stomach.
Ooh, that's kind of...
So you're looking out the window, and you just see like another like fishy hand come up and just starts like rubbing your chest.
It was cool at first. It's not cool.
Why was it cool at first? You're in a relationship with me, you asshole.
Leanne, help, dude.
Oh, okay. You want my help.
Ellie's trying to jump on the ceiling. She's kind of like trying to get Stevedore. Vampire Stevedore.
Okay, that's going to be...
Jesus, what's happening?
That's just straight body. That's just straight body.
Oh. Well, I wasn't supposed to roll an extra dice, but yep, no successes, so I get him.
So you jump up and grab baby Stephen Dorff, but jumping up takes you out of the moonlight.
Uh-oh.
Oh. You just turn into a normal person.
Oh, no.
As you both fall to the ground. So... Chrissy,
does she fall back into the ground into the moonlight?
No. So you
that would be very painful.
You have been bit. Werewolf blood has gotten on you, and you start to feel weak.
And I also have a vampire bite on my hand. Mm-hmm. I die.
And you start to feel.
I die.
You just die. Chrissy's dead.
The kids can't die. That's not the game.
To be fair, Chrissy is the type of personality that wouldn't want to fight. She'd be like,
I do.
I give up.
Yeah.
And
what?
You just said your first instinct was to die.
Because it's a monster world, and I'm clearly preparing and setting up the GM.
No.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Oh, yeah.
No. Chrissy's lazy and doesn't want to fight for other people.
I go the complete opposite direction as everyone else to go find Dr. Frankenstein.
Oh,
God. As you're weak and everything? Okay, great.
Well, because I'm in a delirium state.
So you leave the kitchen. You're looking outside, and you're seeing Ethan and this fish man starts bringing you down into the water with him.
Ethan! And then
is there a branch or something I can...
Roll investigate.
Ooh, investigate.
Wolfman's got nards.
We're gonna be watching that next week.
One success.
Okay, yep, you do find a large branch.
All right, Ethan, grab on.
Okay, help.
Roll comprehend.
Do you know how to?
Are you
take
smart
this
enough
branch?
To pull the branch?
Oh, yeah, are you smart
nope,
enough to pull
the
branch?
Which is good for me as a monster. Perfect. Boom.
Whoa.
Double snake, guys. I'm a genius.
So you grab.
I'm real good at grabbing branches.
You grab onto this branch. Start pulling him out.
Ricky!
And as you do, you start pulling out the fish man who's like. Coming out of the water.
Why is he coming to?
Is he gold?
Hit him on the head. Hit him on the head.
Well, is he like Spock the fish is a goldfish? So is he like an orangey yellow version of the shape of water?
Yeah, there's like an orange tint to him. Yeah, sure.
I'm gonna try to karate chop the fish.
Yeah.
Oh.
There you go.
That's Spock. Oh.
Roll move.
It's monster Spock.
A two body.
My favorite metal man.
Oh, I got too much move.
Too much. Move.
Too
Should
much
be using my brain here.
You need some Lux.
Don't you have one, or did you already use it?
Yo, I'm the fail master. Nothing.
Didn't you get a Lux? I thought.
So you punch.
He did get
it. Yeah,
I judo chop him.
Oh, okay, good.
I don't even need it, girl.
Okay, well, yeah.
Fish chop.
Yeah.
Oh. Take that. Oh, yeah, I got more where that came from.
As he lets
pal.
Go and goes back
no!
into the water.
No.
Blub, 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 blub. That's how you sound, idiot.
As we cut to Chrissy.
Ethan.
Mr. Frankenstein. Mr. Frankenstein, we got to get back out of here.
You come up.
What
you,
is this?
You start making your way up this large spiral staircase,
what?
And you find
trailing
this large,
my blood.
And you find this large door.
And I start like I throw my right elbow into it because it's like the only thing that's not hurting. Dunk, dunk.
And as you open, there stands this like rigid man in a doctor's outfit.
Yes.
Are you a human?
Once.
Oh.
But I fell in love.
And that turned
that
you
killed
into
you?
What?
What? No, I got my husband's a vampire and he turned me into a vampire so we could live forever.
Oh.
We thought it'd be very tragic if I died as he never aged.
What's your name?
Victor.
I have a question.
Ooh, one moment.
Uh-oh.
Time to H-E-C-C things up, hashtag Ethan.
Time to heck things up, says
ooh,
Cheeky.
Ooh, gonna rev that shit.
Rev that shit.
Rev on that shit.
Rev on that shit.
What was your question? Did you have one?
Can you make me not hurt?
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Lead you over to a medical table and starts wrapping bandages all around you.
Great.
Ooh. He goes to a, whoop.
To finish up, hashtag monster, pirate ghost Toblerone.
Pirate ghost Toblerone.
That's
pirate
a ghost lot.
Torbjorn.
That's yeah, a lot.
Torbjorn.
Beautiful. Yes. Beautiful.
Pirate ghost.
Yeah. So he wraps you up.
Jesus, Lord.
As we all know, werewolves are good at basketball. Hashtag trouble as Teen Wolf challenges Ellie to a game of one-on-one.
Oh, yes. we will get to that.
That is excellent.
As Victor goes over and pulls a lever in his room, and the ceiling opens up as lightning starts striking.
And, like, I'm really delirious at this moment. Like,
he pulls another lever, and the bed starts to lift
up. Oh, this is kind of like a tanning booth that I go to.
Yes, it's going to be the ultimate tan!
Yeah, that sounds so cool. My girlfriend's really going to love it.
Yes, they will, I suppose. As he,
Igor, I have a terrible feeling about what's going on in there. We've got to get back in there.
Okay.
Are you out of the...
How are you?
Are you still in the moat?
Oh, no. That's we're good. Out. And I karate chopped the shit out of Fish Boy, so...
Sure.
I
mean,
aww.
I think we're doing all right. All right. Well, the only way you're going to be able to get back into... And before you finish, the fish hand wraps around Igor's foot and pulls him into the moat.
No!
Oh, damn it.
I wasn't really close with that guy, so I probably should be more freaked out, but no.
poor Ricky.
He's great.
Shucks.
But dead now.
I don't know if he's dead.
Probably dead.
Probably
he's
dead.
Just been pulled under. Just because you get pulled underwater doesn't mean you're
he's
dead.
He's human. He can't
As
breathe.
As we cut to underneath the water, and you see Igor and Spock the fish man. Embracing.
Oh, like at the end of the Shape of Water.
And Igor's long flowing hair slowly on the water.
Ethan.
Yeah.
It seems like you might have been here before us. Do you know any way back in? Did you see anything where we might find some weapons?
Help us.
I can jump.
Are you down
really
there too?
High.
Wait.
Where'd you come from?
I don't know. Was I above or no?
Yeah, you were. Well, you were originally.
You got pulled in, yeah.
Did you float down?
I jumped down. I saw him underneath, and I wanted to help him out. So I'm like,
I mean, I can jump really high. Like, maybe I could jump back into the window. I don't know if there's any other ways back inside.
As we cut to Chrissy on the bed. Lightning.
I'm looking forward to this procedure. My mother says I'm too young.
We cut to Ellie.
Screeching
sound. She's just like, where did everyone go? Because like Chrissy just walked out.
As Steven Dorff is making a sandwich, he's over
it. And I'm just asking him, so because I'm a monster too, so I'm guessing that he's chill with me. So how did you two meet?
I can get together, you know. A group of friends, you're thinking, I don't want to go, and you end up going. You meet the love of your life.
Isn't it always that way? I'm so single.
Aw, that's so sweet.
It was nice. You know, he's rigid. I have an attitude problem. It's great. We get along really well. We're really opposite sides of a coin.
Aw, and you got a really nice place.
I'm small. He's really tall. It's great. And thank you. Yeah, I like to decorate.
This is great. Yeah. Do you know where my friend would have gone?
Which one?
Oh, the one who wasn't looking so good. The one that you bit and then I spilled my blood on.
Oh, she injured?
Yeah.
Victor! Little Steven Dorff with his sandwich goes like...
What kind of sandwich does do vampires eat?
Steak.
Like this raw?
Yeah.
Raw steak, rare.
It's like bleeding through the bread.
Gross.
And just like walking. He's wearing a robe, by the way.
When did he change?
Real quick, he's a vampire.
That's
Frankenstein's monster still looking out the window. Are you going to sit there all night?
Oh, is he like their son? Aw.
He's not bright. I love him, but he's not bright.
Aw. Well, harsh. I mean, just give him time. I'm sure he's just trying his best.
I mean, yes, he's trying his best, but giving him time, he's not going to... Clean your room! He'll be there all night. He goes up the stairs.
Ellie goes and like kind of gives Frankenstein a nice little pat on the back, saying, "It's okay, dude. I understand harsh parents."
He looks down. Puppy! He picks you up and just like hugs you.
Ow!
And then continues to look out the window.
Could be worse.
As we cut to Victor's room, as he pulls the lever bringing down the bed, and he undoes the chains.
Oh no.
He takes out, puts like his stethoscope and starts listening to your chest. She's alive!
I was before!
Fair!
What have you done to me?
I have made you whole!
What?
What? What are all these things on my body?
You are now a mummy!
What? What was that word?
Mummy!
But my beautiful, sexy body is hidden up.
It's the same, just rotting.
But it's...
Oh.
What?
That's all I have for you.
I go to his neck and I use my super mummy strength. Oh no! I'd like to be like a mummy from Zelda and I jump on him and suck his life force.
Oh!
Roll
move.
That's a real that specific cool. reference.
Toxic.
Yeah.
Oh, they're frightening.
They're terrifying. Oh yeah.
Frightening. So I lose one. Oh, I'm a monster now. So I gain one.
You sure yeah. are a monster now.
You gain one.
First
yeah.
things first.
You don't love me for who
brains,
I am?
No,
wow. If I get a fucking success, damn it, motherfucker.
Because that's what I'm.
So as you try to jump, that's when tiny Steven Dorff comes in and like, ha! And takes you to the ceiling.
Shit.
What are you doing to my husband?
She ain't having it.
Who the fuck are you?
You know this.
Why do you have no memory?
I just got like hit with a bunch of lightning.
Oh, he drops you.
Ah!
He turns around. Victor, I told you to stop doing that. I told you.
Are you guys going to fight? Because, like, I can go.
We're fighting right now, yes.
Okay, so I'll see you later. Thank you, Victor.
We're not fighting. We're not doing this in front of other people.
Well, it's okay. I'm good. Thank you so much for what you did. I think you helped me. Not quite sure. Peace out, yo.
Could you send our son up here, please?
Who?
Our boy.
Who's your boy? You're going to have to describe him.
Frederick. He's tall.
You're assuming I've met this person.
He's a tall man.
Oh, you mean
than me.
That dopey looking motherfucker that's all sewn up together?
Yes, our child.
I got it. No Thank worries.
You. Thank you.
I like start heading down the stairs.
Thank you.
Frederick T. Monster.
Frederick T. Monster.
Is that what his name is? For real?
No.
As you start making your way down the stairs and you see Frankenstein's monster holding on to Ellie, looking out the window.
Snap. Hey, Ellie, what's up?
What happened to you?
Do you want him to eat you?
No, I mean, he thinks I'm a pet right now.
Do you want me to help you?
Yes, please.
Say please louder.
Please, Chrissy, help me.
Tell me how great you think I am.
I always think you're great. I've never...
You don't say it out loud, though, so like, I want to hear you say it out loud.
As the monster turns and looks at you, are you my mommy?
I am your mommy.
Oh, my God.
Chrissy, I think that's a very bad idea.
I don't know.
He grabs you and holds you himself.
Oh, baby, you're gonna have to let your mummy down. We're gonna do reading time.
What book?
Good Night Moon.
Read it already.
But you haven't heard me read it.
Fair.
So reasonable.
Roll charm.
I have to fix my mummy.
Reverse charm.
Oh, shit. That's
monster charm.
Oh, go.
Monster chump.
Oh, shit. Motherfucker. Oh, thank gosh. No successes.
How close are we to the hyper hydra?
Oh, that's our next monster.
Oh
my God.
Bless.
As he puts you down.
And Teen Wolf.
Yeah, I gotta find Teen Wolf.
One-on-one with Teen Wolf.
Let's go to my room.
Gosh.
He takes you both.
Wait, but your daddies want to see you.
No. As he opens the door, and you see a creature with three heads sitting in his room. These my friends. We talk about comic book movies and Star Wars.
What are comic book movies?
You have my favorite books. He walks over, and they're all books about normal people. There's my book called Cleaning Man.
Cleaning
and
Man? What does
scary.
He do?
He cleans up messes. They want to talk about it. So they're going to remake the Cleaning Man movie, I heard. And, you know, I think it's going to be great. But I think the main thing about the casting about the Cleaning Man movie is you got to make sure, as this whole conversation is happening, this is great. They do this every week.
Do they? Are they your slaves? Do they live here?
No, they're creatures.
Got it.
The Hydra Heroes.
Hi, Hydra Heroes.
Hi.
I don't know how to make my mummy work yet.
The three of them look at you.
Perfect. It's good.
The three of them look at you. Hey, you want a burrito?
Is it a California burrito?
What's that?
Never mind. I just need to put my son here to sleep, so you guys gotta.
Okay, we'll be done. We'll be done in a minute. They're gonna take 35 more minutes. We'll be done in a minute.
No. No, so you don't understand. Like, why don't you gotta go?
Or Ellie is enticed by this Hydra because they're talking about, like, clearly lore and stuff of this world. So she's like, oh, I'm in.
So as we heard, they just fired Gun James.
Gun James!
From the Normal People of the World movie.
The Normal People of the World.
Volume 3, because he said some stuff, and Count Dracula's supporters were very unhappy about it. And they did a bullshit campaign on the internet. We want to talk about this.
You guys, he's a little young for this information. Mm-hmm. And I respect your jobs. But now's not the time. I attack them.
No! No, you don't!
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
roll,
you do.
Roll
Adam
force.
Died and Warhammer's going to die in.
Don't tell Adam that he's died in everything I've been in.
I wonder why.
He's fully aware.
Fuck a success.
So,
yay!
As you go to attack him, you only hit one of the heads and kill it.
Which one is it?
Augustine.
Cut off one, two to take its place.
Well, yeah, two is going to take its place. That's the thing of a Hydra.
Yeah. So as soon as you do that, two more heads pop up.
Two Augies?
Yeah, to
two also Augies.
To have a deep conversation about their favorite character, Tall Boy.
Tall Boy.
Oh, shit. We may be out of our...
And I'm going to say you're in trouble right now because you did attack one of them. As they start throwing their burritos at you.
Do they have like an innumerous amount of burritos?
Oh, it never stops.
Yeah, that's out.
Wait, can I use nerd talk to kind of like, because I'm nerdy in my own universe, can I try to like connect with them?
Okay, roll Copperhead.
Oh no, uh-oh.
Yeah, that's
smart. The thing I'm real good at. Ruh-roh.
I believe I can.
Whoa, that's no successes.
Wow.
So, okay,
you
try and nerd talk him. What do you?
Whoa, I'm so excited for Cleaning Man. Do you think this next Cleaning Man picture is going to be a lot stronger than the previous one? I mean, we're looking at a much more complex plot here with different janitors introduced, right?
Ellie, do you just want to go on a podcast with him or what?
One of the heads of the two new heads. One of them's like nodding, but one's the evil head. What do you know about Cleaning Man?
I'm a huge fan.
Prove your geekiness, girl.
Oh.
Wow. Gatekeeping in Monster World.
I don't think any of these. I don't think any of those guys are gatekeepers. But,
that's why there's the evil one.
That's why he specifically said.
Look,
very specific.
I don't need. I am happy to talk.
We need truth in our normal person comics.
I'm happy to talk comics with you, but do not. I do not need to prove myself in front of you, as you do not need to prove yourself in front of me.
This goes down as the last thing you ever GM here. It's so good.
But
let me tell you.
Hey,
hold on a minute.
No.
No, you don't have a minute.
No.
You don't have a minute.
What if I?
And the other three heads are looking at
her. I'm just going to say this. What if I told you I knew the script. I saw the script for Cleaning Man 3.
Still trying to prove that you're geeky.
They all go quiet.
Well, I'm trying to now I'm trying to just get them to be quiet.
And then the evil one goes, Ethan Van Sciver is actually from this world.
Yep.
I believe it.
Pull up a seat. They play okay. A seat at the podcast table.
I'm just shrugging at like Chrissy, like I'm just gonna stop attacking.
As Frankenstein's monster hands you a book.
Okay, this is not Goodnight Moon. which book is this?
This is
Frankie.
Go the fuck to sleep.
Go the fuck to sleep. Okay, all right, well, fine. Where did my go? Okay, I'm just so concerned about how I look. Okay, Here we go.
As we cut outside.
I wanted to read
Ethan's
it.
And Ethan's been jumping like for like.
Yeah.
Just not high enough.
How about you guys use your vampire strength to open the door?
Oh.
And we can
yeah.
just go right inside.
I guess we could try that.
I thought about that.
Yeah, yeah. If and we do that, it, if we do it at the same time.
When that happens, you hear.
Has anybody tried to help Igor?
Who?
He's gone. He's so gone.
He just was the way out, but cool.
I can see what he's doing. I don't think he needs help. No, he's just fine.
Mm-hmm. I'm not here, but.
Yeah. All right,
spirit.
Well.
we'll find our own way out.
Yeah. I use my vampire strength to do it, to pull the door.
We can do it together.
So you're ignoring the Echoplex.
Do we see it? Yeah, switch to the Echoplex.
Let's say you heard it.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, well, look around. Do we see it?
You hear it?
You see there's glowing. You see there's glowing in the river.
It's what,
in the in the moat.
What color?
Oh, no, it's just the Echoplex.
Okay.
So you don't see what color. But you see the outline of, like, Igor and the fishman.
Okay, you guys work on the door. I'm gonna check this out.
Okay.
Jeez.
Okay.
What
priorities?
About Igor, though?
No, he's fine. Like, look at him. He's having a ball.
No, I want to help
at least.
Igor. I have to help.
You can help
Igor.
So you're jumping in to help Igor.
I'm going to get the Echoplex.
Oh, did you end up doing the cutscene of underwater or no? Because what happened underwater with him?
Oh, yes. No, it's happening. It's
yeah.
Oh, they are. Okay.
It's happening.
It's going down.
So she's going to help him?
Yeah.
Cool.
Battle of this fish man.
He's getting helped. I can see it.
Yeah. Ethan, you're not being very nice in helping people out.
Oh, that's real different than me usually.
Wow.
So you've jumped in.
Yes.
Wow.
You get the Echoplex.
Yes.
You open it up.
Okay.
And at that point, you just see, like, you look over and you see very briefly, Fishman has Igor's legs wrapped around
okay.
him.
Okay.
Oh, right. Man, they're doing
you know
it.
If they're both happy, then that's
hey,
that's
they're happy.
That's
and
fine.
You jump in the river
that's
and
fine.
Try grabbing Igor, and he's like, yeah. Whoa.
No. Let him do it.
And you pull him out of the water.
Igor needs some too. No, dude.
I'm going to focus on the Echoplex.
You open
how could you?
Let's get the door
very
open.
Focused.
You open up the Echoplex.
Yeah.
And out comes a key.
Oh.
Okay. What does it look like?
It definitely has kind of like an old style big kind of look to it.
Cool. All right.
Hi, puppy.
I'm going to try it in the front door.
Okay. So you come out of the water, and as you're coming out, Igor's yelling. Leah, what's your problem?
I was trying to help you.
Why are you making fun of my voice?
Why are you guys talking like that?
I said it's my accent. Wasn't yours, and you might have misunderstood what I was saying.
You
said,
sure sounded British for a minute.
I said I was
which
trying
is an
to
accent
help.
I believe I'm doing.
I was trying to help you.
From what?
From being underwater, fighting something. I don't know.
That's what you think farting is?
Yeah.
What's fucking?
Oh, that's a big word.
What?
I told you to leave him alone, man. He was doing just fine.
Is that what y'all were doing? I had this.
It was more sensual than that, but I'm being blunt.
Oh, you know what? I'm real sorry. I'm real sorry, Igor.
Well,
I just thought you needed help.
Oh, you know what? Intentions matter. Yours were good. Appreciate the apology.
Is
okay.
Is he staying above water? Is he going
yeah,
back
no,
in?
Yeah, no. The fishman, if they only come out once every 100 years, that's why making love to them is one of the best experiences in the world.
Spoken from personal experience, I'm sure, Cameron.
He's gone.
I know what to do with
spoken like He's a true gone. Fish fucker.
Well, we need to get this door open, man. I
all
can't.
Right. I found a key.
Wait,
that's not the key to that door.
All right.
As Igor reaches into his pocket and pulls out
the
no.
key. No.
Just opens the door.
Motherfucker. Could he have keys to the cell the entire time?
He unlocks it. I think I'm strong. I'm like, yeah, I got it, guys. Ugh. All
right.
Yeah.
We need weapons, and we need to find our friends.
As we cut back to the podcasting room, you guys are like reacting to a trailer to Cleaning Man as the evil one's been killed.
Good.
And it's been replaced by another good one.
So two good Augies.
Yeah. As they're watching this trailer, and you see this broom come out. Oh!
And people are typing, going, oh, that chick knows nothing. She's so annoying. Don't invite her back.
Those are our YouTube comments. Don't worry about it, though.
Yeah, we haven't learned how to tell them to stop yet.
Oh, the janitor's outfit! As you're like trying to read this book of this monster. And then you start hearing a dribbling sound in the distance, but only you're hearing it. You're picking it up with your wolf
with
senses.
With the ears.
Wait. Hey guys, do you hear that?
Jesus Christ.
No? Am I with
they
you?
Are they are in this trailer.
Yeah. Weird. Hey, I'm gonna dip for a second. I'll be right back though.
We're not gonna stop the trailer.
Sure. I think that's fine.
As you dip out, you see her going, and he's...
And the fucking moon went to sleep. Good night.
Good night. He grabs you and goes to bed.
No!
As you get out of the room.
Ellie! Oh, I can't breathe. Ellie! What?
There's a ball. I have to go to it. Yeah. I'm a dog.
As you like... Push open, and then again, this castle for the most part is like really cobwebby, kind of dusty. Aww. You know.
I mean, I think it's aesthetic.
Yeah,
no, it's. I mean, it's a choice.
Oh. Oh,
I
yeah.
think.
But then there is right. this as you, the dribbling gets louder and
there's
louder.
There's no bugs in this castle though, because there's plenty of spiders, which is great.
Many of spiders. As you approach this one door, you push it open, and there is a pristine new basketball court.
Okay, what? I mean, they have their own cinematic universe here, I guess. I shouldn't be surprised by a basketball court.
And the dribbling is coming from...
But they use heads.
The dribbling
Fuck
is,
yeah.
The dribbling is coming from the most sexy 80s looking werewolf you've ever seen in your life. Just a mane of hair.
Oh. Gets my little werewolf self up a little dander.
What?
Hey.
Gets my little werewolf dander up.
Oh, dander?
You start
getting dandruff?
No, it means like when you get your dander up means like, oh, get kind of like, oh, hey.
Excited.
Oh, my goodness. Is that a Southern thing?
What's your name?
My name's Ellie.
Oh, shit.
Cool. As he turns around and you see on the back of the name tag, it says Bobby.
Oh, shit.
Bobby, is that you?
Because he has werewolf hearing, he turns around. How do you know my name?
Idiot.
Ellie gets up.
This is dumb, Bobby.
Ellie gets up real close. Like, what have I told you? We met in another life.
Oh God,
I believe it.
Are you just playing some basketball in here?
Just keeping my game strong, you know. Hoping to get out of here, get to a good school.
Are you trying to escape from here?
Trying to always get away from my dad. He doesn't get me.
Oh, I missed you so much, Bobby.
I heard you. I don't know what that means, but I'm guessing that's me from another universe.
It is.
Are you a werewolf in your universe?
No.
Good thing you're a werewolf here.
Whoa! Ellie's kind of like, yay, but like also, what does it mean?
Yeah. We're gonna fish fuck.
Yeah.
Ellie's not ready for that. No.
No, she's not.
She's
at all.
A baby. Stop.
She's a little baby.
You don't talk about my friend like that.
They grow up so fast.
She's a big girl.
You no, she's not. She's a baby, like I said.
But she's in dog years.
Yeah. Exactly.
Oh! He right, though.
Shit.
She's
Lord.
Definitely mature enough for this.
Hey.
She's actually getting old up there.
No! Dear Lord! What is happening?
Hey, you play the game, girl?
A little bit.
And you catch it. You catch
yeah.
it.
Whoa. Does being a werewolf make you really good at basketball?
Fuck yeah.
Apparently.
Do they break? Do they pop the ball with their fangs?
Basketballs are real tough.
Just questioning.
What do you want to do with it?
I'm gonna like let's shoot it. I'm gonna shoot that sucker from the 3-point line. Let's do it.
Let's play a game of horse. You go first.
Mm. All right.
Or I'll call it wolf.
I mean, horse is better because it has five letters.
Yeah.
He don't give a crap.
We call it Bobby, and it'd be good.
What's your name?
Ellie.
Yeah, let's call it Bobby.
Okay. That's not a Bobby thing.
I like this guy.
You would. Whoosh.
Okay, we start playing.
Whoosh.
Do I roll to play horse?
I'm going to say you make that because you're going first.
Whoosh.
Bobby grabs it. He makes it.
All right, let's number two.
Yeah, you're up.
Great. I'm going to shoot now. Watch this.
I'm watching all of it.
at least thinking to herself, okay, this is, I don't know if I like this Bobby. This Bobby's a little, this Bobby's a little too much. He's a little too much. I like sweet, much more geeky kind of chill Bobby.
Team Wolf's best friend comes up and goes, yo, dude, take it a little slower. Slow your roll. She's a little, she goes, scare easy, bro.
Yeah, Ellie's kind of like, Ellie's playing horse, but then she realizes, like, Chrissy's is still in trouble. So Ellie's going to take that basketball, and she does not a huge, I don't think she's a huge fan of this Bobby because he's a little, like, he's a little too creepy. He's a little too monstrous.
Yo, dude, she's so picking up on your monster.
Yo, Bob, you gonna revel in that shit or not?
Oh my gosh.
These are my homies, by the way.
Are they really here or no?
Yeah.
Shit, okay. Ellie's still gonna turn around and throw the ball in Bobby's face and try to run back to Chrissy.
Because
I thought mine was a treble.
The enemy to all mummies arrives, the Scorpion King. Half rock, half scorpion, all hashtag monster.
Top body rock, baby.
Is it like, is it the rock or is it rock?
No, it's the Scorpion King.
The most realistic CGI you've ever seen in your life.
It's the rock, right? It's the rock, isn't it?
Top half is the rock, the other half is a scorpion. Let's go.
Sexy.
So roll move.
Too bad it's not the other way around.
The ass of a scorpion.
The ass of a scorpion?
And he crawls on the ceiling.
I remember that now.
It's that is no successes, so I do it real good.
You hit Bobby right in the face like, hits the ground, and he's immediately knocked out.
Wow. Where are we at? Are we there?
Hey, you two, even though I'm a monster, you still treat me like a lady. Fuck off! And then she runs she runs to go find Chrissy.
To his homies. He's
like, whoa, dude, that was cool. Cold.
As you go running, and Frankenstein's monster at this point is like falling asleep.
His nose is really large, so I use both my hands on either side of his nostrils to close them, so that he like kind of ruffles, so that like it kind of wakes him up. And so hopefully his arms jostle open so I can get free.
Okay. Oh, his arms kick open.
I jump out of his arms.
As the Hydras look over.
Hey, I'm one? Not. Nope. Nope. I start like ambling out.
And you walk right out. The moon rock right out. And as soon as you do, you start hearing these large, long, loud stomping sounds.
Ellie? Ricky? Fucking left me, motherfucker.
And then out of the shadows. You see these giant snappers come out. What's your name?
Oh. Hey. My name is Mummy.
It doesn't matter what your name is! As he grabs
the chopper. Oh my
god! Yeah.
I really like it, Ruff.
What?
I'm gonna take this scorpion claw. Shine it up real nice. Turn that son of a bitch sideways and stick it straight up. You can't eat ass.
That sounds really like non-consensual sex, and that's not okay.
Oh, my God.
I look for
his... Scorpion King is just like...
Mind blown by that.
I will say at this point, Ellie, you are seeing this, and there's a little bit of moonlight between you and the Scorpion King.
Oh, heck, let's do this.
Whoopsies.
Gotta take it. Dogs are real good at biting scorpions.
And this time, it's less painful transformation. It's almost like right through the moonlight, like you transform as we cut to you guys, making it right through the hallway again.
We need to find Ellie and Chrissy.
We need to find me. I mean, Chrissy, you know, the other one.
Yeah, she's not you.
Well, I saw like some lightning and there was some screaming and she might be like a monster.
God damn it.
What do you mean?
Knowing Chrissy, she might be cool now. She would be a monster by now.
I wouldn't say in trouble, because I mean...
You start hearing these chain sounds dragging.
Uh-oh.
Hello?
What's... hold on. We don't know
Hello!
What is.
Hi.
Who is this?
What is happening?
Hello? Who is this?
Hello!
As you see a pirate ghost Toblerone come walking out.
Okay.
I died on the seven seas, a man of candy.
Oh, yeah.
I searched to find out
I remember
new treasures.
I'm
last time. So what's the difference with your candy now? Are you dark chocolate now?
Yes.
Dark chocolate.
I'm full of nougat and I'm a gold pirate.
Do you guys know this guy?
Well,
it's Toblerone.
We've seen a version of it before.
Does he have blood vessels?
No. I'm broken into multiple pieces.
Yeah, he's not really going to be
my only weakness. And I'm also a ghost.
You're a ghost of chocolate? So what? If I break a piece of you off,
chocolate? You're a ghost.
So we can walk right through him and keep doing our shit.
You have no calorie gain if you eat me.
Oh, well, I am trying to watch my figure.
This expired 2 days ago.
Living life on the edge.
It's all good.
Hey, it says there right there that you expired 2 days ago.
Chocolate
what
never
exactly, exactly.
Chocolate never expires.
No, I know. It's great.
So, I expired 2 days. My milk has curdled.
Ew. So what would anybody want? Like, what's your point of existence if no one can even eat you?
Can we help you?
Whoa.
What's the point? Yeah,
my God, you've gotten me. You've gotten me
do you need
in my head.
Do you need something? You just seem to be wandering the halls.
Yes,
what can we do for you?
I'm looking for my lady love across the ocean sea.
But you're in a castle.
Yeah, she might not be here.
Oh, well, you gotta take me out to sea.
That's
you know, wait. In the moat, there's a fish man who can definitely help you.
Yes. Oh, I've heard of such things. He comes every 100 years. But if he's already mated, you'll never find him.
I don't think they finished.
Oh,
so
gosh.
I think he might be able to.
I think he's down there and he's ready to go, Daddy.
He might be waiting. So I think you're good.
My goodness gracious.
It's going to give you all the information you've ever needed to know. I promise you this.
Yeah. Hopefully he likes my curdled milk.
Oh, my gosh.
The milk curdling tales from the loop.
I'm gonna try to do my Rick James hypnosis on him.
I already said I was going.
I think we're good, Ethan. I think we're good.
Well, I'm just standing here like, oh, okay, yeah.
As we cut back to the Scorpion King, you're wolf jumping.
And you're
gonna roll comprehend whether you attack the Scorpion King or Mummy Chrissy.
Oh my God.
I mean, I hope I knew. Oh, gosh. Hopefully, Chrissy, we're not too
for two.
Well,
it's a werewolf. Who knows?
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Really quick. Did Ethan do his instinct rolls as well? Did that happen? I missed it.
What? Sorry. You
got an instinct roll, didn't he?
Did I?
No, you got a reroll.
Oh, that's what it was.
Got a luck, right?
I could use an instinct, though.
I could use a reroll.
Well, no, it's too late now.
As you jump and you grab onto Chrissy, the Scorpion King's like, I don't need a tag team partner. And he hits you away and sends you flying across the room.
No!
The three of you hear this echoey, hoo!
It's got to be Ellie. Sounds like a wolf.
Oh my gosh, it turned.
What do we do?
Igor, I need a weapon. I'm the only human here.
All right. He walks you to the...
Help me, Igor. Help me.
He walks you over.
You're my only hope.
Opens this door, and inside are, like, just all the weapons you can ever think of.
Just casually, just the weapons closet right next to the pantry. Easy miss.
By the way, you said this key would not open the front door. Does that mean you know what this key does?
No.
Okay. I'm going to hang on to it. And
I would
take all the weapons.
All of them?
All of them. As many as I can carry.
You must have real deep pockets.
I'll tell you, he knows how to use these weapons.
I'll grab a couple.
I know firsthand.
What are you taking?
I'm taking a couple of daggers.
All right. What are you taking?
Two daggers.
A crossbow that shoots wooden stakes and a sword.
I want some weapons.
Okay.
I want this.
Here's some stink bombs.
Perfect.
And a bag of sugar.
Awesome. My favorite weapons. Wait. I see a long thing with like metal teeth around the edges. What is that?
Chainsaw?
I've never really done much yard work, but yeah, it's a chainsaw.
Oh my God. Of course.
I guess.
Yes.
It's heavy. Okay.
I'll take it.
Yeah, it's full of gasoline.
Rang-a-ga-ga-ga. Yeah, I can rev on this shit, dude.
It's back. It's back. That's it.
Okay.
Hashtags.
As you guys start making your way, you've been
is
hit
that Ethan's cash?
Rev on that shit. Yep.
Yeah. Wow.
You've been hit across the room. The Scorpion King has you against the wall.
Wait, Scorpion King. Wait.
Eyebrow raises.
We could mate.
Oh my gosh!
What?
Ellie's just like.
Okay.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
He puts you down gently.
No!
He takes off these scorpion pants that take a long
Not
time.
Not right now!
There's like 10 legs.
Not right now! I just meant like we could court. I don't have to eat meat. I might be dateable.
You were not clear. He pulls his pants back up as he starts to buckle the pants.
Ellie's just like, I'm attacking him. Like, F this. No! I'm a baby!
You jump on top of the Scorpion King as you guys start. That's
I
want to
rip out his jugular.
All right, roll force.
Let me do it. Heck yeah, I ripped that thing out real good.
So you guys come up the stairs, weapons ready, as right when you see Ellie rip out the Scorpion King's throat and blood going.
What the hell
Holy
is that
shit.
Creature?
What did we miss?
No!
He puts his hand out to Chrissy.
You're gross.
He was kind of handsome.
He dies right there.
Yeah, but he's going to kill me.
I think Ellie's the champion now.
Oh, I think that does make her the champion.
Yeah, the title belt comes floating down from the ceiling.
Ellie, you.
What?
Ellie just like what? A dog, she just kind of bites it and then starts shaking it. Like,
that's
a good
not champion. How you treat a bit, Ellie. Ellie, you stink. Like a wet dog.
Wait. Chrissy, is that you?
Yeah, what the fuck happened?
I don't even fucking know you. You can't talk to me like that.
Did you get cool all of a sudden?
That's Chrissy.
Excuse me? I go straight after Ethan.
Oh, you're so fast.
She is a Zelda mummy, so yeah.
Oh, shit!
Zelda
mummy.
So roll force.
She's a Zelda.
Stop it, you two!
Come here!
I know she got blood vessels. Oh, shit.
Oh yeah, there's a bunch of blood on the floor everywhere. Is that triggering y'all? Or
well, yeah.
And scorpion
like,
blood.
I got one success, which means I didn't
Wait,
succeed.
Well,
blood.
You
got
to roll to see if you move out of okay. it, and if you get two successes.
It's move.
Yep.
Frig.
Oh. You have to get no successes
I
in order
know,
to move.
I got
away.
A lot of move though.
Me too, because you are me.
Come on.
Do you have any
luck?
Uh oh.
I got two success, so I do have a luck.
Okay, so he's using his wall.
Come to Papa.
Well, get her, Ethan. Get her.
I'm getting her.
Got a success. So I got smoked, boys.
So you two just like, you two like.
Come on!
You two jump, and Ethan, you like, you avoid each other as Ethan starts lapping blood off the ground.
Guys, stop.
That's not
Listen,
even
look.
Human blood.
I almost go after Ricky, and then I calm down.
You're opposites of each other. Mm. I understand that this is weird. Just stay apart.
Where were you this entire time? You completely abandoned me.
Igor.
Just like you completely abandoned me at the hotel. It took forever to find me. Do you know that that friendly person, the foreign entity, was the only person that was nice to me? You always...
We came back for you.
After months.
It wasn't months to us. We
it
came as soon as we could.
We came as soon as we possibly could.
You guys need to
stop fighting because even though you guys... are the same person, we're going to find a way for both of you to stay in the same universe.
There can be only one!
Stop! Ethan!
I go after him again.
Stop! I interfere. Like, I just like...
So, we just got to our next monster, so as you do that, you suddenly feel the castle starts to vibrate.
Whoa.
Because the monster that was opened up was Yojimbot. As the castle starts to vibrate.
Whoa.
Are you guys doing this?
And...
No!
Starts to launch into the sky like a ship.
What the fuck is happening?
Oh my. Arr?
A thing you guys don't see is what? Victor. Is Victor behind the controls of the ship going, I told you it would work!
We don't see this.
And Steven Dorff is like, okay, you turned it into a ship.
Ellie's having like flashbacks to the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
As it's going up, and as it does, they have to open up some controls for wind resistance, and it looks like bunny ears.
Aww.
Igor, do you know anything about this?
Yeah.
What's happening?
Hey, what's going on?
Oh, Master wants to turn the castle into a ship to see if there's monsters on other worlds. Stupid.
What?
But we're from the other worlds.
Well, no, I mean other
worlds
like,
in this
space.
Okay.
Not like dimensionally speaking.
Okay.
Wait, can vampires breathe in space?
I don't know. I'm sure.
I'm having a hard time breathing here.
According to
you
True
scare
Blood,
me.
According to True Blood, you guys can breathe in space. I believe.
Do they go to space in True Blood?
I think they do. I think he goes like. I think he's. He goes to Siberia for sure, and you see some vampire penis. It happens.
What show is this?
True Blood.
What episode?
It's one of the last ones.
Perfect. I'm going to look it up.
All right, so.
Maybe now is a good time to get out of here.
Yep.
Okay.
And Igor leads you guys back down to the weapons room.
Yeah.
He opens up, and there's a couple of jetpacks and parachutes. All right, choose.
Wait, you're just going to throttle us back down to the world? We were safer in here.
Well, if this thing's going into space.
I think you missed the whole part about going to space. The oxygen's
thin. How do we get back to our Earth, our home?
We'll find out when we get back down there. So, parachute or rocket? Rocket pack.
Rocket
put a,
pack.
Put a parachute on her.
She already called a rocket pack.
No! Oh, no. Here goes a dog with a rocket pack.
I'll take one of those rocket packs.
Rocket pack.
Sure.
I mean, we might be able to survive in space. You want to grab one together?
Oh, huh?
Can it hold two?
Rocket pack.
About to find out.
Okay.
I'm just going to drop.
Oh, my.
So you go to the window can I jump?
No. Wait.
Igor looks out. Well, there you go. He snaps on a parachute and jumps out as well.
And now I got to try to dive and catch you. So.
My Marty erotic bag of play.
Mission Impossible Fallout
yeah, exactly.
style.
So what are you doing? That's a dog with a rocket pack.
Like, I feel like Igor like someone put it on me real fast, and all of a sudden you just see the boom, like this dog just like take off.
As you go shooting out of the castle. And past the moon. Like E.T. The two are you alone for the first time.
Fuck.
The rocket pack?
I'm kind of afraid of heights. I mean, should I put it on and I just like grab onto you? Or?
Fine, but I don't know why. They might have had two. I don't know why we decided to take one. That's just like in the front.
I'm not good at making decisions, okay?
Apparently so. We kept trying to fight Chrissy. I didn't like that. It's not her fault that she's in the universe and you're not, okay, Ethan?
It's not my fault I'm here, man. I just keep, like, jumping around all nimbly-bimbly.
I know. I don't know why Echo brought you over there, but I guess I didn't train him. It's a lot of
I
work
guess
to
not.
Do.
But you know what? Having a first dog, it's, you know, you move on to the next one. You move on to the next
one.
Yeah,
okay,
so
all right. Okay. But what if okay. I feel like Echo's a forever dog. I got to keep him forever. I got to train him.
You know, he's probably still out there, and we can find him.
All right.
And this rocket pack might be the way to get there. So, what button here? It's a big red
okay,
one.
Okay, the big red one. All right, click it. Go.
Bingo.
You guys go right through the ceiling. And just boom.
Fuck shit. Ow.
Through the basketball court, hitting, knocked out Bob. Knocking him on his back. Through another floor, you go through the computer. The hydro's been watching a trailer reaction on. The computer burst through that room. And out of the castle.
It's beautiful out tonight.
Look at all these stars. I gotta count them all. Let's start counting all the stars.
Are you hungry?
Yes!
Dude, you feel the compulsion to start counting all these stars?
I was not really good at math.
You can't help it.
You can't help it. You gotta count them all.
Gotta count them all.
Count.
Gotta count them all.
Vampires.
As we cut to your body just turning in velocity.
This is great. Some thought what feels like last week.
And I'm jetting out. Yeah, the whole like leaning forward. Got the rocket pack going.
How great. Are you so good at that?
Tinker. Good. Not good.
You're gonna die.
You first. I'm going to use that luck. Oh, no.
You better fucking roll a six.
Yay! Got one.
Woo-hoo. So you, Iron Man 3 style.
Oh, yeah.
Just grab onto her.
Am I Pepper in this scenario?
No, she wasn't in that scene.
Oh, I don't remember.
Iron Man 3, the airplane 3. Scene. You just saw it.
It's fine.
Oh, let me go talk to the Hydra hero.
They haven't seen it.
unaware of that motion picture. So as he grabs you.
What's wrong with you?
What? For saving you?
We cut to Ellie the dog. It's like a dog when they stick their head out a window. Just the first.
The best thing ever.
Does that feel like
yeah. As Igor's just slowly floating down. It's nice. It's really peaceful. This is the first time I've been happy in a while.
Not even when you're having sex.
That got ended. That did not get to finish.
I'm sorry.
It's like floating his way down. as you guys make it down to the earth.
Why did you save me? I'm a horrible, hideous monster. I don't deserve love.
What are you talking about?
I'm in love with somebody else.
What?
Uh-oh.
I'm not just a monster because I look like a mummy. I'm a monster because you're my rebound.
Who is it?
Mar.
I don't want to talk about it.
As Igor, lands near you guys. Ah! All right. Who's ready to get going?
Well, considering I'm the only human and everyone else here seems to be monsters, maybe just you and me should go.
Aren't you coming?
No.
Oh, boy.
Hello. No one.
And, as we cut back to the two of you, you're still just going up.
I decided to come back down.
I guess we're actually going to space. I don't know how high this shit goes.
Maybe we'll break into another dimension. I don't know.
If we go fast enough.
Oh my god.
Do you think I'll go back to where I belong? Do you think you'll go with me? Faster!
I don't know.
Why are you going to go with me?
We come back to you with the dog.
I feel like she's been she's not landing.
And you start actually heading towards a wooded area. And as you get under the trees, you're out of the moonlight. You turn back into you.
Oh no! Boom! 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 Branch! 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 Oh gosh! Oh damn!
As you land right in front of Igor and Ricky. Hello.
She spits out
a bird.
Hi.
All right, we're gonna try and get out of here. You coming with?
Yes.
Peach,
you ready to get out of here?
I don't know if I don't want to be a dog anymore. But where's Leanne and where's Ethan?
I'm gonna go back to Leanne and Ethan. As you're speed demoning up.
I want you to be nicer than you are.
Ooh.
You're not nice.
Snap. I'm super nice. To popular people.
Be nice to yourself. Be nice to Chrissy. Even though she can't be in our world or at the same time that you are, you gotta be nice to her. She's not a bad person.
I'll also say you still have your chainsaw in one
hand. Oh my gosh, yes.
Oh. I'm playing with it. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Oh my god.
I hate Ethan.
Typical Ethan.
I can be nicer to Chrissy.
Please.
We butt heads. I mean, who doesn't look at yourself? You ever looked at yourself in the mirror and seen your flaws? Seen what sticks out? Seen what you need to change? Yeah. It's hard for me, okay? I look at her and I see what's wrong with me. And how can I be okay with that sometimes? There's a lot wrong with me, but I see her, I see what I need to change in myself. So yes, there's something I can work on.
It's too real.
Well, you better make an effort.
Run!
Did you let go of the jetpack for a sec just to hold on to the chainsaw?
He's got a rev on that shit.
Chainsaw's pretty cool.
Stupid.
It's a good find.
Stupid.
But you're right.
We gotta find Ellie though, okay?
Okay.
Find Ellie.
And you guys start going. And more and more, as ice starts to form around.
Oh no! Avengers! Let's it's been real cold, Ethan. You can turn around, maybe.
Don't let go, Jack.
No, and we go all the way.
I want to see if I can find where Ellie landed. I want to roll for
Not in the sky!
No, but I want to land. I want to fall down to where you
are. Oh, gosh,
don't fall.
Roll
comprehend.
Don't fall.
Well,
Use your jetpack. I guess, yeah, you are a vampire.
Yep. Vampire.
You can float.
She
so
fly.
Comprehend, does mind, and I have 3 for mind, and I have no comprehend because I'm dumb as shit. Let's go.
You can.
Wow.
Yeah, no success.
So you were able to unclip
as
you fall. Ethan, you're still going up.
Leanne!
I wanted to take him with me, but come with me, Ethan, please, come!
Okay. I can't get it out.
Oh!
Use your chainsaw.
Oh, God. Strong,
good. Fuck!
As his legs pass
your
body. I think it's working.
Oh, no!
Brutal.
Vampires grow back limbs, right?
They're like lizards.
Sure.
His legs go falling fast.
Wait, so is your torso still, like, flying up?
No, the torso comes undone, and he falls, and you're face-to-face, but he's upside down, Spider-Man 1 style.
Spider-Man kiss!
Oh, I give him a Spider-Man kiss. I'm going to give him one of the upside-down kisses.
Just kiss anyway. We'll believe it.
I was waiting for the headsets to go, like,
and then... jetpack above explode.
Oh, like perfectly timed, so it looks like a firework.
Yeah, so it's like above them as they're upside down kissing this firework.
We probably look really cool.
I look up and I'm like,
are those legs?
That feeling.
No, and then you're like, and then Ellie looks up, are those legs?
What the hell?
Stop making fun of my wrappings.
No, there's actual legs falling from the sky.
As I say that, as I look up, the legs hit me
probably
in the face.
Yeah.
In the crotch.
Oh!
Although,
no! I told you to be nice to her!
Although, the scent is familiar.
I'm done. Wow. I'm done. Wow. Nope. Out. Bye.
It's got that familiar concoction.
Oh my gosh.
That pre-shower smell.
We all know it, and if it's personal, we love it.
No, not anymore.
Oh my.
No.
I'm being real and honest. It's like day 2. It's not day 3.
Oh my gosh!
As you land, holding Ethan's like torso up.
Why
are your balls in her face right now? Stop it, Ethan!
Dude, I had zero control over this shit.
Okay, alright, Chris. Alright, sorry. Break it up!
Okay. Yo, legs or not?
Is that gonna go back together?
As I just grab my legs, like crawling torso.
Yeah.
As we fix this, Ethan, Chrissy, Ethan has something he needs to say to you.
What is it? I'm a horrible person.
You know what? So am I in a lot of regards, but at the same time, I think there's a lot of love we can give. And
you're dating Leanne, though.
I think there's a lot of. I've been a dick to you, and for no reason, because I see a lot of things in you that are wrong with me. And I think if we get along, then we can
bring out the best in each other.
Yeah.
I want to say that at least I think whether we get along or not, it's exciting that Leanne has found charming qualities in you, because that might mean she actually feels the same about me in some ways.
I think so.
You're okay.
You're not bad yourself.
I get real embarrassed, and then I just like, okay, all right, Ethan, we need to fix that. That's Ellie.
Yeah, I don't know about sewing people together. Igor,
I mean,
you,
we can push the parts together.
You were
and
your
see if they reattach.
You were Dr. Frankenstein's assistant. Do you know anything about putting bodies pieces together?
I could give it a go.
I mean, I trust him more than anybody else here.
Why would you? Because wouldn't he fix his hump?
Okay,
you can't. That's too difficult. All right.
I've got this. We cut to 20 minutes later, and Ethan is facing the wrong direction.
But his legs are so
nice. I kind of told you guys.
He's looking down at his butt.
That could be interesting.
Nope. I mean, nice, but nope.
Listen. I did it in the dark, in the woods, with very minimal tools. I think I've deserved some accommodations.
But I'll to be fair, I would tell you about 5 times that you were doing it backwards and you still did it.
Yeah.
So,
all right, let's begin the journey.
I guess you gotta walk backwards.
All right, let's get out of here.
Wait, Ethan, no, someone's gonna have to push him.
He could walk backwards. He can see where he's going. With
I him. Offer. A hitchhike to Ethan because I have super mummy strength and I'm feeling like shit.
All right.
That's okay. You can piggyback my busted ass.
Yeah.
So since his legs are here, let's that go. Means you're facing this.
he's my C-3PO. Okay.
Yeah, you're Chewie with C-3PO.
Shit, Ellie and I are walking behind waving.
I'm actually okay with this.
I mean, does it hurt?
Emotionally, yeah, but no, I'm cool.
Okay.
Emotionally, you know what? That's probably some of the most.
I mean, I guess, like, how are you going to go to the bathroom? That's a big question.
Well, I mean, I guess he just goes backwards. Like,
sure.
Maybe just
how
sit down.
Do you poop, right? You don't
you just
see
sit
your
down.
Butt.
You just sit
this
down.
Is pertinent conversation.
This is my body you're talking about. I don't know. I don't know. We'll figure right, it out,
let's
okay?
Let's get the hell out of here.
Ellie goes to check in with Ricky. Hey, are you. I don't know what you two were talking about, but are you okay?
No.
Oh.
No, we just gotta put all this behind us. Just gotta get out of here.
Okay. Well, if you need anything, let me know. Okay.
All right.
Okay. hey, I go over to Leon. Hey, so Ricky is not doing good.
You know, I don't know why. there might be something between the two. They've been mighty distant in terms of like.
Oh no! No, this is why you don't date in the group, because this breaks up the group.
Why do you think I date someone from a different universe? Come on.
Well, same hashtag. Oh, oh there's no hashtag.
There might
what
be.
What the hashtag?
I heard one of the Hydra heroes talk about it.
Oh,
it sounds
my.
Like some kind of fun lingo thing.
Okay.
Pound sign.
Pound. Yeah, it looks like a pound sign. But
well, what do we do about that?
I think all we gotta do is just be the nicest Leanne, the nicest Ellie we can be, and just. I don't know. As soon as we get back, nice vacation sounds nice. Maybe I'll just go get Billy's pizza and we all just kind of hang out one night and watch a movie or something.
No, fuck
fine.
Billy.
So we pinky promise to take care of everybody else. Okay?
Yeah. And I promise I will not go back on this promise.
Jesus.
You still stink really bad.
I'm sorry. This, you know what? I don't know.
As you guys start making your way through the woods and Igor is like.
You know that song?
Is it much further?
Yeah.
I hate Igor. I liked him, and now I hate him. I don't think he's taking us anywhere.
And then you guys hear,
Ellie, stop making noises.
Was that?
That's not me.
That wasn't you? Was it?
Somebody you know?
Do I recognize this howl?
Yeah, do we know if it's...
Can I howl back? To try and communicate?
Oh, no.
Can I ask, like, who are you?
Yeah, you can if you want to. Roll comprehend.
Okay. Aw, darn. I'm gonna...
Actually, you know what? I'll go charm.
Good.
You want to fail this one, though, girl. Don't forget.
And that's a fail.
Which is a success.
Which is a success.
Boom.
Who are you?
As Igor, like, just goes,
oh, no.
You don't get it, do you? You just sneak in.
I'm trying to communicate with it.
Why?
To tell it, we're friends. I'm telling it the dog version of like we're friends.
Oh, did that work back at the castle when you were in human language?
I played basketball. Hey, I played basketball with some of them, and they were kind of weird, pervy jerkos.
We're a couple
and,
vampires. We don't really get along
so
with
this
werewolves.
So this is you telling me it worked, is you play basketball with a weird, pervy jerko.
I threw a ball in his face. Yeah, it worked.
Yeah, you made real good friends right there.
Are we about to have to kill some werewolves?
And
is
then,
that
like,
what's
you
happening?
Hear a response back. My name is Mallory.
Mallory? Well, their name is Mallory, so we got that.
That doesn't mean shit.
I
met some real tough dudes named Mallory.
I mean,
you guys, stop giving Ellie such a hard time.
Wow. For once, I appreciate that.
What are you doing?
I'm a mummy.
Here, let me say back. Let me talk to Mallory real fast.
I try to grab one of her arms and put it down.
Ellie howls back.
You probably don't want to touch that.
Mallory, we're friends, not foes.
I'm a demon.
Oh shit! Is that not a werewolf?
Igor looks at you. What'd she say?
So.
Did she say, "Are you my best friend? We're gonna be really close.
I will kick your behind.
All right, Igor.
She said, thanks for giving me your positions and telling me where you are.
She said, "I'm a demon."
Oh, did she?
Let's just go.
Beauty. Good thing you responded in hell.
I want to punch Igor in the face with my werewolf hand.
Roll force.
With the paws.
Scritch. Oh, no! Scritch. I got a success, so that's a failure.
Uh-oh. As you punch him in the nose, you hear a break, and then it goes back into place. That's not the first time anyone's punched me in my nose.
Wait!
Why does your nose go back to place?
Humans don't do that.
I thought you said you're a human.
Did you not see the hump? I'm clearly very defected.
Then why don't you fix your hump, idiot?
Okay, Chrissy.
We did this.
But if you could fix your nose.
Do you want a rerun? I'll give you a rerun. I didn't fix my nose. It did it its own. And it's not really fixed. It's tender. Real tender.
All right.
Any other questions?
No, we need to hide.
We got a demon dog we're about to deal with.
Yeah. Maybe we shouldn't talk to
the
demon
dog. I go walking towards the demon dog because... Oh, please.
You know what? No one stop it.
and me talking to it was so bad.
I guess I'm going with her. She's carrying me, so sure. I got no say in the matter.
I'm not thinking about it. I came to
Let's go.
You go walking up to this dog that's like red eyes. It's like, and it's a giant corgi. And just drool is dripping. A drool is just dripping from its maw.
Look at him. Here, girl.
Is that grabs you both. It grabs you both.
Ethan grabs it!
I've already been ripped in half once today, dude.
Maybe we can fix it if you get ripped in half again.
Okay, bite me here.
He's just shaking the shit out of the two of you.
Oh, I deserve it.
Yeah, I go in there and I jump on that motherfucker.
As you try and grab it, it does the dog thing.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to run around the other side and attack it with the sword. I'm going to attack it with the sword.
Okay.
I'm coming for you.
What do you want to do?
I'm going to go after Mallory.
Okay. How so?
Do you want to date her?
I'm just going to go around the other side while the demon's distracted with Leanne.
It's not Mr. Bubs.
I'm going to...
The chat saying it's Mr. Bubs.
Not Mr. Bubs. I'm just going to run around and just going to wail on that dog.
Stab it!
Okay, pissed
roll,
off.
Roll sneak.
Sneak.
Hey.
I asked for this. I wanted this. This is what I want. I deserve this. Don't
Shake
try to
hold
me. No! What the? Stop! Stop what you're doing!
Two successes.
Oh.
Two successes. So once it does another one of those dodges, you come out.
I'm pissed off. I'm seeing red. I'm going to kill it.
Oh, dang.
Oh, Mallory? That's messed
okay,
up.
Okay, tell
it's
me
a demon.
Tell me what you do.
I go around behind while Leanne is distracting it, and I just chop off its head.
Okay.
Dropping all these body parts to the ground.
You come jumping down, and you chop, and as it hits the ground, its head falls off rolling. Yep. With you two still in its mouth, so you're rolling. As it comes to a stop.
Ethan, do I have all my parts?
Ethan, are you okay?
Dude, I have no idea.
Oh, wow. Ellie kind of looks at Ricky for asking that question.
Yo, you Ricky, you looked really fucking cool when you did that.
Igor, can you fix this
you saved
now?
Me, man.
The proper way, please?
Am I fixable?
Yes.
All right. Well, listen, the bigger question was, what was that demon dog guarding? Was it guarding the way out of here?
My boyfriend's in pieces. Can we fix this first?
Igor's going to fix him.
Sure.
Don't worry. I got this. Can I borrow some of your bandages?
Oh, Lord.
I start pulling off.
We cut to 20 minutes later. somehow, Ethan and Chrissy's both halves have been put on top of each other.
Oh,
Oh, come on!
So you have Ethan's legs and you have Chrissy's legs. Listen,
Igor, this
listen.
Is a bloody mess. Wow.
Hang on. I could
tried.
Yeah,
I mean, it's like that scene in like Scooby Doo when they strange bodies.
Igor,
but,
have you ever seen
the R-rated version?
Do you know what humans look like?
Yes.
I don't think you do.
You're gonna blame it on the nighttime again. That you
strike two, buddy. Strike two.
I'm gonna blame it on adrenaline. A lot of adrenaline.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fair.
I have a pretty strong feeling you're not very good at your job.
My job is not surgeon. You'll keep going like, Ego, fix this. They'll be like, Ego, go to the moon. I'll do the best I can, but it's not what I'll do.
Listen, are we close to getting out of here? Maybe when we get out of here, maybe you two will be put back together.
Yeah, or, and hear me out.
Okay.
If we want to give them one more shot, I could cut them in half, and then Igor could... It's up to you. I'm not going to make the decision.
I mean, it's the bottom half of your girlfriend is on the bottom half of my boyfriend. And
probably
going to
want that
there.
Back. Yeah.
Probably going to want that back before they have to use the bathroom. I'll be honest.
Fuck it. Do it.
Right? Do it.
No, I'm good.
No! Shit! That's right. Not for you!
I mean, you
like
both have equally good calves.
It sounds like we're having a real debate here, and we need to solve it.
Okay, I guess I could get used to that.
I don't deserve anything.
If you decide,
so.
But I'm progressive, so I'm going to leave this up to you two.
I look great in heels.
You can wear heels whether you're male or female.
That's true. You just got to get bigger size.
I never thought of that.
Yeah.
Man.
It's fine if you want to. I don't care.
Chrissy, don't say that.
I don't deserve anything. I run off into the woods.
Oh, my God!
With your new male football player legs.
So I'm going a little bit faster. Are you a tight end? Or
my jeans.
Oh, shit. Are you a...
He's a quarterback.
Quarterback?
So,
yes, I'm not really good at running.
But
I guess I could.
He's pretty, like...
Yeah, no,
he's
no.
He's good at maneuvering.
Yeah, so I'm dodging trees. I'm like stiff-arming trees. Like, Heisman!
Heisman. Jordan.
Chrissy, get your ass back here!
No,
literally.
I'm over
that ass!
No, it's his ass, yeah.
I know, that's what I'm saying! Chrissy, get Ethan's ass back here!
Damn,
you only
fast.
Care because it's his.
No!
Not true!
Ellie's gonna turn it because there's some moonlight.
Yeah, they're camera.
Great, Ellie wants to change into a werewolf to catch up to Chrissy.
Okay. As you go, you form into a wolf and start heading towards Chrissy.
I'm picturing like the Skyrim transformation where it's like, brah, 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 brah.
As you go running towards Chrissy.
Shit! I forget that she's a werewolf. I keep running.
No!
No, I'm kidding. I stop.
This is going to be a whole thing. This is a whole thing right now.
I stop and
how are you?
I just want to get out of here. I might be the only human left in God knows where the fuck we are and what's happening. I just want to get out of here.
All right. As Igor hears you, he pulls out his giant thing of keys, rubs away some dirt. You see a little keyhole in the ground.
So we were here? Okay. Do you have the key?
No.
Is it this key?
Oh, my gosh.
I don't know. Give it a try.
Well, let's wait till our friends get back. We don't know what this is going
to
do.
Ellie's turned into like a sheepdog, and she's trying to herd. She's trying to herd Chrissy back.
Yeah, and you tackle me to stop me.
So you're on top of her.
Ellie, stop! Turn into a human.
Can
for
I
a
transform
second.
Back, or do I try to find myself some like? I mean, we're
yeah,
in the
can,
woods.
Roll comprehend.
Okay. Uh oh. Right row. Yep. Oh, that's two fails.
So it didn't.
No, yeah, that's two
Ellie,
successes.
Ellie, I'm a bad person, and you won't remember this because you're a dog. Exactly. I'm still in love with Katana, and I am in love with Ricky, but if I'm in love with both of them, it's not fair to be in love with Ricky. I know you don't understand, but I should stay here.
Ellie starts to like kind of she puts like she grabs Chrissy's kind of like collar of her shirt and starts trying to pull her towards.
What are you doing?
The...
Oh, you're right. I should go and figure it out. No, I'm not that interested in that. No, I think you're right. I think I should take a break from Ricky.
Ellie licks you in the face.
as you start to see this glowing light coming from the forest.
They're in trouble.
And out comes walking. Out comes walking Spock the Fishman, holding hands with Toblerone the Pirate.
Who are these people?
Hello. My name is Spock. My journey has completed, for I have found a true love. It is this giant candy bar pirate.
Okay.
Bar?
You're probably wondering why I'm here.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I'm here to show you there is another way.
To what?
To happiness. Bar? I felt a great
disturbance in the
sadness. A great sadness. Dealing with love. And it is my job to come and help people in such situations.
You can't possibly understand the situation I'm in.
I'm a fishman who's been cursed for near millennia. I can understand the ways of troubles of love.
Well, here's one. The person I fell in love with for the first time ever in my life is not available, and then there's a perfect person that I'm in love with also who's right here, but I'm only going to break his heart if I just don't know.
As he bends down in his goldness, he touches your shoulder, and it feels very warm and loving.
You know what I call that?
What?
Being a teenager.
What the fuck does that mean?
Meaning this will happen a lot, and that's okay. It's okay to feel a lot of different things.
Well, what do I do? Do I break up with the guy?
You said you found your one true love?
I found a true love and then found another.
Well, I think deep down, you'll need to ask yourself, who's going to make you the better you?
Myself.
Well, then I think that's the answer. I think maybe you need to be alone and find out who Chrissy is.
Scary. Are you okay? Thank you, Spock.
Thank you, Chrissy, for being you.
I don't know who that is.
That's why you need to look.
As he opens up his hands, Toblerone wraps his arms around the fish, and they go into the sky.
Who would have known? Toblerone's story, man. That's, you should have never fucked around with that Cadbury bitch.
As we cut back to the woods, and you go walking up with the key, you put it in, and nothing happens.
Shit.
That was.
All right, you still got that chainsaw?
Yeah, I do.
Get the fucking door open.
So what?
Say it with me.
What the fuck is the key
Rev
for?
Rev on that shit. Ring.
Rev
gung gung gung.
Rev on that shit. Ring. It's just all these wood splinters come chopping up.
Is it working?
I think so. I can't tell.
How?
Have you ever used chainsaw before, Ethan?
No.
No. Okay. All right. Well.
Okay, we're going. Okay.
Did it work?
It's a little messy, but I mean, there's some glowy shit coming out.
Yeah, yeah, sure made a big mess.
Oh.
As you two, are you two coming back?
Yes.
And you're turning back into a human.
What the heck? Whoa. Chris? What the hell, Chrissy? Come on.
We're all good now. We don't need to worry about that.
I think we found the way out of here.
Great.
I go and I give Chrissy a hug. I won't give her a hug.
I give Chrissy a hug too.
Do I smell like rotting corpse?
Yeah,
a little bit. A little bit.
You stink. Oh my god. Sorry.
And
I know
jockstrap.
I love you very much, but I'm just going to let you know right now that you two are the smelliest woman I've ever smelled. And it's real bad.
And then Ellie kind of like rubs herself all over you two and like, yeah.
Stop!
It's a smelly.
Stop. Okay.
Ugh. Nice.
All right. Well.
As Igor bends down and pulls the door and there's a stairway leading down.
Do you know what we're going to find down there?
Yeah.
Great. Let's go.
All right, here we go.
Confident little bugger.
Well, Igor, are you going to be able to fix this, by the way?
Fix? Oh, yeah. I think. Maybe. Probably. Yeah.
Third time's a charm, I guess.
Yeah.
Right?
Well.
As he gets down, and you start hearing sounds, what sounds like laughter, people enjoying themselves.
What?
This is creepy.
Are there other people
down
here?
That can't be right. After all the shit we've seen tonight.
And as you come into this large room, you see it's a giant banquet hall. And all these people stop to turn and look at you. And one man stands up on the end of the table and goes walking up to Igor.
What are you doing bringing monsters here?
As Igor goes, it's all right, hold on. Everybody, this is the human resistance in Monster World. Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm Leanne.
That's Leanne. So, hello. Sorry, we ruined your door. I lost the key. I'll admit it. I'll take on that. But listen, how's everybody? The leader of the resistance looks like super pissed. And he goes, what's your story?
Me?
Yes.
Well, I fell in love with the girl. And then I fell in love with the boy. And then I got turned into a mummy.
That's the most human thing I've heard all day. What's your story?
I'm a human from a different Earth, if this is, even is an Earth, and I'm just trying to get back, trying to put all this behind me. This place sucks.
We're doing the best we can.
I was trying to help my friends and trying to protect them, and then I got bit by a werewolf, and then I ended up here.
Yeah, I'm an alternate reality version of her. And
the same could be said. I'm an alternate version of him.
And I've gone back and forth, and I woke up, and hey, I'm a vampire.
I'm Leanne. Hi, I'm a new vampire here. I didn't used to be one. I am from the same place that those three are from. Not this one, but this one's my boyfriend.
No.
Yeah.
Hi.
And yeah, we're real lost.
So you said you're from an alternate universe.
I don't know.
Seemingly. I don't know. I mean, not this world. We're not from here. We're here.
There aren't these kinds of monsters where we're from.
Nah, these monsters are in movies.
What's a movie?
Well, you have a cinematic. You know what a movie is. You clearly clean.
We live underground because we are human beings. We will be hunted and killed.
Yeah. Movies like a story with pictures and sound that you project on a wall.
Ethan, stop. I know they smell real good. Stop.
Uh-oh. Please ignore them.
See, do we need to watch out with him?
Yeah, might be.
We should get, cool. If you've got a way to help us get going.
Yeah, we just need to leave. We need to get out of here.
Do you have a Hadron Collider?
We don't belong here.
What?
Do you have a Hadron Collider?
What is that?
Never mind.
It's a thing in our town that's from our universe, and it kind of produces a bunch of monsters. It might have something to do with why we're here now.
You mean like the Dracula's castle?
What?
Huh? That's where we ended up, the Dracula's castle.
No, we were in Frankenstein's castle.
Yeah.
What does Dracula's castle look like?
Large, the middle of the town, glows.
Yeah.
That's it.
A vampire castle.
Take us to there.
Can we go?
Why?
They're not going to take us.
What?
They're part of the resistance. They
show
get
us
killed.
How to get there.
Why do you need to go there?
We need to go back to where we're from
so that
we don't get hunted and killed.
I don't think you need to go there to do it.
Yeah.
Oh, well, then be more clear with what you mean.
You guys are asking me about, do you have this thing? I said, what's the thing? You describe the thing. I go, yes, we have it. Now you're telling me to take it there.
New question. Have you ever seen glowing boxes about this big?
Are puzzle boxes that big?
Gold one.
I don't know how big. I thought. I mean, they shift in size. They're
a spell box.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, spell box.
I can solve them.
You're not the only one that can solve them.
It comes out of his breast.
Everyone at the dinner table kind of freezes. Those are not to be trifled with.
No, they're not.
Yeah, we figured that out.
It's kind of what brought us here.
But do you have any of them?
Come with me. As he leaves the banquet hall and all these people are like watching you guys go go through.
Hi, I'm Leanne. Hi, I'm Leanne.
Hi, you smell good.
He brings you into this room.
Stop.
He opens the door and you see there's a chest. And around the chest is a bat, iron wings clasped around it. We're not sure what's in there. We haven't been able to open it.
Oh,
I mean, wait, where'd you get that?
I still have a key that we haven't found what it does.
Where'd you get that?
I found it. Something otherworldly may have given it to me, but that's about as easy an explanation as I can give you.
Takes it, puts it in the lock, and when he turns it, like dust almost creeps out of the side of it.
Ooh.
lifts the box, and you see a number of puzzle boxes sitting inside of many different colors.
Whoa!
More than we've seen before?
Blue, green, red, gold, black, and purple.
Purple? Oh, my word.
Open the gold one.
Well, no, we know that blue will send us back to our world.
I mean, maybe. I mean, things could work differently here.
Yeah, but if we go back to our world, is Ethan going to come with us, or is he going to go back to, or is he gonna stuck here? No.
What do you people know about these spell boxes, as you call them?
Don't fuck with them.
That's it? There's no...
What was the happen last time someone tried to open one? What color was it?
It's gold.
What happened?
Yeah, what happened?
You got us on the edge of our seats here. What?
Sorry. Just thinking about what happened.
Yeah.
Seemed to develop powers or something. I don't know what you would call them. And well, he became very dangerous.
I mean, that's what the black ones do.
Yeah.
Why is does gold any different?
Well, he was dangerous in that he became... Sound cut out on. Can you guys hear
me?
Still?
Hear
you. Yeah. Okay. He became dangerous because, in his power, he tried to change the world. The monsters killed him for it. Powerful enough to take down some, but not all.
So, gold box is good?
Well, I mean, Ricky's, it kind of sounds like what happened.
Gold, come on.
What, does Igor know about any of these things?
Say again.
Does Igor know about any of these things?
Igor looks over, and it's like he's like,
"Oh, let's keep him back."
Don't worry.
Well, what? Do we try a blue puzzle box and we try to get us home,
I'm
or do we go to
so
Dracula's?
So hungry, Ricky! I'm gonna kill you if you don't do this right now. Make a decision.
What? We don't know what this purple one is.
You have us
tasty.
In a room full of humans right now.
As you guys
right
are arguing
now.
And discussing, Igor walks over and grabs the gold one.
Uh-oh.
Oh, fuck. No hump anymore.
As he starts to turn
and pff, this gold light goes around him and blinding to you guys. And as you open your eyes, Igor stands there and he is buff as hell.
Is he hot?
He is completely fixed and his clothes seem to have turned into a cape.
Oh, I'm opening up a gold box! Hot
you
darn!
You enough boxes with you.
I take the blue box as quickly as possible and try and solve it.
As you start to solve it, Eeyore looks, I'll save this world. It goes through the ceiling.
Ellie would like to pocket a gold box for later.
Okay. Roll sneak.
I want to see what that purple one
we're
is.
We're grabbing, yeah, I was going to say I want to grab purple, but...
Jesus. Okay, that's a fail. So
you know
success.
What? Because
I grabbed the gold box.
Because I know that Ethan may not return with me, I'm going to take a red box, so just in case something. So
roll
just
sneak.
In case.
Why a monster box?
Because this is the only world that I know that I can meet Ethan in.
Shit.
Are you stuck here, Ethan?
You might be.
I don't know.
With Chrissy's legs.
That's what? That's you said it was.
Not the worst thing ever.
It was sneak.
Yeah. But you got mummies for legs.
Mummies for days.
Uh-oh.
I got two successes.
Nope, sorry. None.
So no you try to sneak.
I grabbed a gold box successfully. Let it
you
be
you grab
known.
A purple.
I you take the blue one and solve it.
You solve it. And when the light hits the blue, the red launches out of you, launches out of you,
blah.
And launches out of you. And your legs go... As this light,
my jeans are really expensive. Oh.
Takes over the room.
Classic.
And you guys look as you fade away, and Ethan stands there with the leader of the resistance.
Oh,
ooh.
Ethan! Ethan!
Classic prank.
Classic.
You should see the look on your faces.
Good luck, man.
As you guys. Yeah, as this light goes off and you guys land back in we're in the comic book room.
Yeah.
Comic book shop.
Yeah.
As you guys land back in the comic book shop and there was still the tentacle creatures. So right as you land, they start to vanish because now that Chrissy's back.
Oh gosh! Oh no! Right, it's been there for a while.
And Carol's like,
did you want to do anything with the tentacles before they go?
No!
Just checking.
Carol's like, like with this bat.
What was she doing with them?
Fighting them with this like bat with
Y'all
nails
nasty.
In it. Her clothes are kind of ripped up, and she's been at this for hours.
I go to hug Carol. Carol!
Where did you go?
We were in a monster world.
We lost Ethan.
The end.
I don't know who that is. Wait.
I'm sorry I left you alone with that.
It's fine. I know you had tomorrow off, but I might need you to come in to help clean.
Yeah, I'm happy to help.
And I want to hear about Monster World.
It's really cool.
Ah!
Y'all, I think we need to get Carol, like, a drink.
As you guys start to lead Carol out, you two are alone.
We have to break up.
That's pretty much what you said.
I just wanted to be clear.
All right. I mean, if there's somebody else that you love.
It's not that. I just need to figure some things out.
All right. I mean, time or is this just goodbye?
We can be friends, and I can't say I know anything. I just know that I don't want to be the cause of pain over and over again, and that's all I'm good for, so. And I'm not treating you well.
Everything in life is full of pain. We know that better than most people.
Yeah, so why add to it?
Because you can find enjoyment at the same time.
Great, then we'll find enjoyment as friends.
Alright. We'll see.
And then walk out.
As you make your way out. As you make your way out.
Oh gosh.
We cut to the three of you, two of you, as you're leading Carol.
Oh.
Where are we going?
Oh, I'm not legally able to purchase you alcohol, but I feel like, I don't know, in the movies I've seen whenever people are exhausted or something, they're like, I need a drink.
The dark room won't.
Can we just go get a burger?
Yeah, let's go get here, Leanne. Let's go get a burger and a shake. Leanne?
Yeah.
Come on, let's take care of someone.
Good philosophy.
Okay. Are you okay?
As we cut back to Monster World, as the leader of that resistance looks over at Ethan. So you call those jeans?
Jeans.
Yeah, like really fucking nice jeans. I could get you some.
Okay.
Okay.
What? As you start to hear this echoing, whoop, and here appears Echo with Mima.
Oh!
She bends down, pets Echo's head, looks over at you. You're Ethan.
Yeah. A lot of people know me, so I'm okay. Not surprised.
She is dead.
Yeah.
You're seeing my granddaughter.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Do you want to eat her?
Hi. Have we met?
Not yet. But I'd like to get to know you, and I'd like to recruit you.
I got nowhere to be.
As she puts out a hand. You shake hands. We cut to Chrissy's house. As you come home, and your mother is setting up the dinner table.
Mom, I'm home.
What'd you do today?
Nothing. I'm just going to go up to my room.
Okay. Hey, real quick. Your cousin's going to be in town.
No.
Oh, my gosh.
She just left.
I know, but she said she wanted to come back because she wanted to show you a good time for Halloween.
Wait,
you know that
Halloween?
Means she's going to try and get me drunk.
Live the adventure, baby.
Mom.
Damn.
As we cut to Ricky's house.
Does no one recognize what the phrase is from?
It's not the same.
The Adventure.
Yeah, it's from the computer. It's from the computer.
The computer episode. The cinnamon episode.
As Ricky's dad is sitting on the couch eating a big old bowl of spaghetti.
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 Hey, Dad.
Hey, bud.
Everything going okay?
I mean, I got a bowl of spaghetti and I'm watching TV. I'm living the life.
I'm glad to hear it. I'm just gonna turn in early tonight.
Okay. Hey, what are you gonna be for Halloween?
What is our timeline?
I wasn't really planning on getting dressed up or.
We can make a costume.
We could.
Yeah.
Did you have any ideas?
Oh, I got some stuff I can think of. I want to make sure you're living the adventure.
Oh God.
What is it?
Oh my God.
Are we in a thanks, Dad.
Oh no.
As we cut to.
No, I thought it was over.
As we cut to Ellie's house, Ellie's coming up. Hamburger bag in hand. As you open the door, and there's your mom. Hi, baby.
Hi, mom.
How are you?
I'm doing fine. Are you okay?
I'm great. How was your day?
My day was good.
That's good. What did you do? Sit down. Tell me about it. Did you get food and didn't tell me? Naughty girl.
What? Mom, I gotta check her head. Do you have a fever? Are you okay?
You touch her head, and when you do, there's almost like an error.
Ellie kind of steps back for a sec.
What's wrong, baby?
Sorry, it felt like, I don't know, I got a little chill, a little goosebumpies.
She touches your head. You are feeling a little warm. Maybe what if you go to bed and I'll make you a hot chocolate?
Okay, yeah, I'll go upstairs and go to bed.
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Sounds good.
Yep, sounds real good.
As you start leaving,
I have a question for the DM.
Mm-hmm.
Is Johnny the computer still in the back of Leanne's truck?
Where's
or
Leanne?
No, I said I carried Johnny the computer back up to my room, so Johnny the computer's in my room.
Mm-hmm.
Yes! Oh gosh, yes! Good job, Ellie. I go to turn on Johnny the computer when I'm up in my room.
Well, you start making your way up the stairs.
Oh no.
And there's another glitch, and you suddenly find yourself outside your house again. With
you
your burger bag in hand.
I immediately start running to Leanne's house.
As we go to Leanne's house.
Mom?
In the kitchen.
Mom, what are you doing in the kitchen?
And she comes in. I'm making food for you and Mima, duh.
What do you mean, me and Mima? You mean just me, right? And you?
And then you hear, do you not want me to eat, silly?
Oh, no.
I turn and I look to face that voice.
And it's Mima.
Oh,
this is not her.
Elderly as you last saw her.
Oh no.
Mima, what are you doing? When did you get back? What's going on? When did you get here?
Back from where, baby?
From the other place.
Baby, I haven't been in the hospital for 2 months. Are you all right?
What? Mima, what's going on here?
Dinner. And she goes over to the table and sits herself down.
No.
How are you?
No.
Are you living the adventure?
No.
No, I'm not living the adventure. Is this you?
Baby, it's always me.
And then I go and I go to hug her.
And it takes a minute. And then you do feel, but it feels very cold and calculated.
Mima, it's not you.
Oh, gosh. No, don't tell that to the program.
And
this isn't you?
You see the smile drop.
Oh, no.
What do you mean?
Oh, gosh, no.
What is this? Is this the common? What are you doing?
As Ellie comes running up to Leanne's house, and as soon as you get near it, the house disappears.
Leanne!
And it's just an empty field there. And that brings us to the end of this episode of Blood Curdling Tales
from the Loop.
Cool.
Yes.
Yeah, boys.
Oh, man. I thought we were finally out of it.
No way,
what
Jose.
The hecky?
We just getting started.
It's back in.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all, thank you so much for watching this episode of Blood Curdling
Yes.
Tales from the Loop.
Thank you for all of your incredible monsters all and donations.
Monsters. Oh, yeah, those were some sick monsters. Let me go through. And we also had some lucks also. Leanne, I believe. Ellie had a luck, and it looks like Leanne might have had a luck.
When did I get a luck?
I didn't know.
Right, like at the last second. There.
Ah, darn it. Okay, well, I got it in her next
one. Last second luck.
And there was, let me see if there was any others. I think, yeah, so Ellie and Leanne, yeah. I think it was basically around the time we were saying we might go to Castle Dracula.
Okay, all right. Well,
which we would have needed them at that time.
Yeah, but I'll take it, whatever.
Time is of the essence. So let's see here. Guys, thank you so much for watching the show. Thank you for everything you really, really helped. Also, next week is going to be, this was obviously Monster World. Next week's going to be also like a Halloween-y episode because we're going to be on the day before Halloween. So we're going to make one. The last couple weeks have been kind of goofy. I'm going to see if next week we can actually make it real fucking creepy.
It's not going to be hard with Kendra here.
Nope, with Kendra.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so we might have MF5 on next week. We got to check some things.
Nice.
If we don't, we'll make it part of the programming. That something is amazing.
You're the first three-time guest. She'll be another second-time guest. So.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Three-time champion.
So let's go
the
through.
Alec Baldwin of our.
Let us go through real quick. Mestu Fanta, Mrs. Manface, Hackmer, Hawk RMB, Arsenal Roy, Damoon Rolls. Damoon Rolls, by the way, is the person doing the podcasting.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for putting those up. Hey, Shy Guy Express, thanks for resubbing.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Awkward.
No. Shadow Uzumaki.
Woo.
Keen 456.
Woo.
Dashing CN.
Woo.
Zakian. Villainous Villain.
Wow.
Jay Pistol. Arsenal Roy. Giant Replacement Baby.
Yeah.
Watterson. Arsenal Roy. Cheeky.
Big Cheeky.
Big Cheeky.
Dashing CN. Arsenal Roy. Doomsday Danny. Keen 456, Arsenal Roy, the Kid Anon, and Doomsday Danny, Mr. Fantasy, and finally Mr. Owl.
Woo, woo, woo!
Thank you guys.
Awesome.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank
you so much for watching this episode. As we said, tomorrow, big day going around. Emily, what's happening tomorrow for you?
Boy, howdy. As it say, it's 4 p.m., right? Yes. 4 p.m.
Is that right? I think it's 3:30.
I think you're supposed to be here at 3:30. Maybe.
Maybe.
Well, I don't know.
One of those.
It's at 4 p.m., but tomorrow afternoon you can catch the conclusion of the Fetch Quest. What will happen? Who will return? How many of Myth's children will continue to appear?
I can't.
Yes, tune in tomorrow for the epic conclusion of the Fetch Quest.
I would like to take two personal seconds and say that my grandmother passed away yesterday, and it's okay, and it was totally like time. So I wanted to dedicate tonight to her. I was going to do it in the beginning. I forgot because I was having a good time.
What is her name?
Her name is Katie.
Katie.
Aww,
Katie.
And she lived to 96. So
yay! 96.
She did a good job.
Wow.
And you have to realize that like because of her, I got here. So there's a lot of gratitude.
Yeah.
For that.
Yes. Thank you, Katie.
Yeah.
Thank you, Katie.
Did you say you had a second thing or you wanted to take
two seconds?
No, that was
it. I wanted to take two seconds for a personal Jessica thing.
Thank you, Katie.
So guys, thank you so much. Next week's going to be our Halloween episode. I think it's going to be a real fun one. And also tomorrow, along with that, we also have part two of He Left It Dead. Which if you want to catch up on, I believe it is on our VOD. It might also be on YouTube's.
Maybe, because it's apparently very good.
I've heard very good things. And then after that, it's going to be Magic the Gathering win condition. So, y'all, thank you. This has been a really great one. This was super fun. Thank you for all your contributions. And make sure you go jump in that Reddit. Go jump in that Discord. Tell us what you're thinking. And you know what? Let's talk about some Halloween. What are you guys going to be doing for Halloween? Tell us. Let us know. Let's hear from you.
Yeah.
And also, speaking of me and Emma, we are going to be on Movie Fights this Thursday facing off.
Man.
We're going to be doing horror movie fights. It's going to be me, Emma, and Clark Wolf.
Awesome.
Check that out. That's going to be happening this week.
Get your bets in.
Oh, I am prepping. Y'all, thank you so much. And we're going to see you all. Thank you for sticking here to Hype Our RPG. And we'll see you all next week for our next episode of Blood Curdling Tales
from the